this year. He is not throwing the ball well. He doesn't have the sharp breaking ball that he had in previous years. He's had a number of surgeries on his arm. He's been on a disabled list the last couple of years, and so maybe this is a guy we can get started with.
Well, stay tuned. We'll be back with our starting lineup.
Detroit Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light. By Bell Tire, for price, service, selection, and location, nobody comes close. Now more than ever, nobody's closer. And by Little Caesars. Little Caesars Big Big Pizza dwarfs the competition.
Get your Bud Light, you can't hit my friend. Let's go. I'm thirsty.
Taste that will fill you up and never let you down.
Looks like you're buying.
Make it a Bud Light.
Coach is calling for the heat.
You know those $29.99 batteries? Try buying one for your car. The battery guy will say, geez, sorry, these only fit a few cars. Then he'll say, but here's one for $69.99. Talk about a shock. Hey, what are those $29.99 batteries good for anyway?
At Bell Tire, get the guaranteed lowest out-the-door prices on batteries that will work in your car. Installation's free.
Here's one thing a $29.99 battery's good for. Well, maybe not.
Bell Tire.
Come to the best place for the lowest prices on tires and batteries.
Steve Eiserman.
Little Caesars introduces Steve Eiserman motion cards. Collect one free with every captain's meal, all for just $9.99.
Pizza, pizza.
Hello, everybody. A beautiful day for a ball game here at the corner of Michigan and Trumbull, the second game of this three-game set. And here's the batting lineup for the New York Yankees. Leading off, Chuck Knoblauch. Batting second is Derek Jeter. The third batter, Paul O'Neill. Batting fourth, Bernie Williams. The fifth batter with a grand slam last night, Tino Martinez. Batting sixth, Darryl Strawberry. The seventh batter is Tim Raines. Batting eighth, Scott Brosius. And the ninth batter, Joe Girardi. As George Steinbrenner liked what he saw last night, and he's back again. Defensively for the Tigers, in the outfield, Gonzalez, Hunter, and Higginson. Around the infield for the Tigers, Randa Ripken. Easily, Clark at first base, Casanova behind the plate today. And Greg Keagle is on the mound for the Detroit Tigers. Keagle has pitched very well so far this season. His record is 1-2. Unfortunately, he has drawn the Baltimore Orioles both times he has started. Pitched pretty well in both of the games, particularly his first game. He pitched 5 1/3, allowed only 4 hits. The second game, he went 4 2/3 innings, allowed 4 hits and 4 runs. But Keagle, much more impressive in spring training. He has a lot more confidence on the mound than he has in previous year. Able to get his breaking ball over the plate and has developed a much better changeup. Keagle has a tough task ahead because he will be facing a tough lineup in this New York Yankee, particularly the left-handed batter. So. He's going to have to be sharp with his breaking ball, keep those left-handed hitters off the plate, and keep the ball down. Wind blowing out towards right field again today, but not as hard as it was last night.
Well, Mr. Knoblauch will lead it off. He has been on base in all 12 games in the 1998 baseball season. Knoblauch, Jeter, and then O'Neill, the first test here in the opening inning against the Keagle. There's Tim Welke umpiring behind the plate. Gentleman from Kalamazoo, Michigan. Tim's brother, Bill Welke, is an umpire in the International League.
And there's a hot zone for Chuck Knoblauch. Likes the ball out over the plate, up preferred. a lot of balls to right field.
And he fouls away the first pitch of the ball game. Strike one on Knobloch. Knobloch had a single and a couple of walks in the game last night. Always up among the leaders in bases on balls. Breaking ball wide, one and one. The count on Chuck. We're underway at the corner. The Tigers trying to get out of a six-game losing spin. One and two on the leadoff hitter. Keagle, a native of New York State, born in Corning, lives in Horseheads, New York. Fouled away.
That's the changeup that Keagle has developed in spring training and has really made a big effect on his fastball. Gives him one more pitch that the hitters have to look for to go with his fastball, curveball, slider. Now he added a changeup to his repertoire.
Keagle got his baseball start with San Diego. They drafted him number six in the June of 93. Then traded to Seattle, and from there came to the Tigers. 2-2, the count on Knobloch. Fly ball hit into short right. Higginson puts it away, one up and one down. Well, a much better start than last evening. Derek Jeter, who had a three-run home run last night, will be the batter. He's been bandaged up on the leg. Came out in favor of Homer Bush in the late innings in last night's game. But he had a single and a home run in the three trips. Here's a strike call on Jeter.
Oh, what a great job this young man has done. It's not like you're playing the outfield for the Yankees as a rookie. He's in probably one of the most difficult spots in that shortstop, and he has held up well and has done a great job for the Yankees.
1-1 the count on him. His mom and dad met when his dad was in the Army, and his mom and dad were both stationed in Germany. 2-1 the count on Derek. One out, we're just underway. The Yanks at bat, first inning. Fly ball, left center, might get up the gap. There goes Hunter, racing, diving, and he grabs it for the out. He outran that one and hauled it in.
We had a great view of that being right behind home plate. It looked like there was no way that Brian Hunter was going to catch up with this ball. They're playing him around towards right field, and somehow Brian Hunter doesn't get a great jump on the ball, but he runs, can outrun this baseball. What a great play by Brian. This is the type of thing that can get a ball club going. Not, you don't always come out of a slump with a base hit or a home run. Sometimes a great fielding play can pep up a ball club.
Two down for the Yanks, and the veteran Paul O'Neill at the plate. Fouled away, strike one on Paul. He didn't play in the game last night, but was 3-for-4 against Anaheim in the last game he played. That was on Wednesday. Paul had a good homestand in New York, 8-for-16.
He's been a hit machine ever since coming over from the National League. He was a platoon player in the National League only against right-handers. Now he has blossomed into one of the better hitters in all of baseball.
1-1, the count on him. Two out, bases empty, no score, first inning. 2-1 the count on O'Neill. Keagle ready to pitch to the one-time American League batting champion. Outside, 3-1 on O'Neill.
Well, this middle of this Yankee lineup, the third, fourth, and fifth hitter, is probably as good as any third, fourth, and fifth place hitter in all of baseball. Tough on right-handed pitching.
There's a strike and the count full. For the last five straight years, O'Neill has batted better than 300. Bernie Williams on deck. Fouled away. That will reach the upper deck. What has he got to look for now, Al?
I think he's going to try to throw in a fastball. They, with Bernie Williams coming up, another power hitting, I think he's going to try to keep the ball down and away from him.
Fouled away. Two out, nobody on. Game scoreless. We've just started here at the corner on a bright, sunshiny Saturday. These two teams will conclude their series here tomorrow afternoon. Drive, base hit over the head of Clark into the right field corner, fielded by Higginson. O'Neill going for two, and he'll go in with a double. That's the first run of the game. O'Neill doubling with two down.
Well, you have to give all the credit in the world to the hitter. I mean, this is a great pitch by Keagle, who has been pitching away, 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 and then all of a sudden he decides to come inside. The ball wasn't hit all that hard, but it was an excellent a time at bat for Paul O'Neill. I thought it was a great pitching sequence, and I just have to give the credit to the hitter on that one.
O'Neill at second with his fifth double of the year. Two down, no score, first inning. Bernie Williams, the switch batting outfielder. Last night drew a walk in the first inning, scored a run, and then went 0 for the next four. And there's a strike called on Bernie. Strike two. Al, you don't see too many hitters wearing the shades.
Well, that's the new thing for these young players today. They wear them not only the hit, but that's also their sunglasses in the outfield. And also, you see infielders wearing them. I question the wearing glasses when you're playing the infield, but that's the new thing today.
Line drive, right field. Here comes Higginson to field the ball. O'Neill rounding third, headed home. Here's the throw to the plate, and it gets past the catcher, Casanova. The run scores, and on to second will go Bernie Williams. It'll be a 1-0 Yankee lead on the single, and then Williams goes down to second base.
Well, here it is again. Two strikes, and he gets the ball up a little bit. And Bobby makes a great throw. It's just a little bit of a short hop to the catcher. And Bobby Higginson will get an error, but look at that. That was a perfect throw. And because the runner is able to go to second base, Bobby Higginson's going to get an error on that. That was a perfect throw, maybe a foot just too far towards home plate.
There's a breaking ball over on the next hitter, Tito Martinez, who in the first inning last night hit that grand slam. Look at that RBI total. He's up among the leaders with 16. Ground ball, shortstop, diving, stopping. Ripken has no play, but he keeps that man at third base with a diving stop at shortstop. Runners at the corners with two down, and the Yankees have come up with three straight hits after two are out.
Well, I mentioned the third, fourth, and fifth hitters, and this lineup is as good as any in baseball combined, and they're the ones doing the damage this time. You don't expect this, and again, you get Tino Martinez hitting a ground ball to the left side, then you've done your job. It's unfortunate that he was able to hit it to a spot where Billy Ripken couldn't make a play.
1-0 the Yanks against the Keagle and the Tigers. Runners at the corners now for one of their hot hitters, Darryl Strawberry, hitting an even 400. He didn't play in the game last night. And the Straw looks at a strike. He was 3-for-4 in the last game he played. That was against Anaheim at Shea Stadium last Wednesday. included a home run. Fouls it away. Strike two, the count on him.
Now that was a good pitch. That was the pitch that he wanted to throw to Bernie Williams, a breaking ball that was down, unfortunately, with ahead of the count. He got the breaking ball up, and Williams was able to get a base at the right field. Watch the location of this pitch. It's an outstanding one down in the dirt.
Keagle's high with the next one, and they count one and two. One nothing Yankees. They've got him at the corners with two down. Fouled away by Strawberry.
Well, Keagle's been able to get two strikes on these left-handed hitters, but he's been unable to get the third one past them.
Strawberry didn't play a whole lot last year with the Yankees. He's wide with this one, 2-2 the count. Strawberry, rookie of the year when he broke in with the Mets in 1983. Two-two pitch, not forthcoming, a little toss to first. Well, with two out, the Yankees got a double by O'Neill, a single by Williams got him home. Williams took second on the throw to the plate, an error by Higginson, and then Martinez had an infield hit to move him to third. Strike called, he stood there like the house by the side of the road, and watched that one go by. At the end of a half inning, Yankees won, the Tigers are coming to bat.
We may not always agree on the best plays.
We do have our differences.
That's for sure. But we do agree that your Metro Detroit Ford dealers can get you more car for less money.
That's more choice.
There's Taurus, the most popular car in Detroit.
Now lease a Taurus SE for only $230 per month with $750 cash back. Taurus comes with a V6, automatic, air conditioning, dual airbags, and more, only $230 per month.
This is my choice. Not much on gas, but good on ice.
Think Ford first.
Gibraltar Trade Center in Mount Clemens invites you to visit our indoor classic car and truck show this weekend. See over 120 displays of the finest custom cars and trucks from Pro Streets, race cars, street rods, and more. In Taylor this weekend, visit our gun and knife show featuring over 400 tables of rifles, shotguns, ammo, knives, and military equipment, all at the best prices in town. This Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, visit the classic car and truck show in Mount Clemens and the gun and knife show in Taylor.
Hi, I'm Mickey Redmond. Mark your calendar for Tony V's 30-year anniversary celebration. For 30 hours only, April 23rd to the 26th, get an incredible 30% discount on any Millennium sunroom. This sunroom concept is so new, so unique, you have to see it. Mark your calendar for your chance to win a Tony V sunroom, Red Wing playoff tickets, or a Tagger Stadium suite night. So don't miss Tony V's open house, the 23rd to the 26th, on Hall Road in Clinton Township.
Well, the batting lineup for the Detroit Tigers, who are trying to stop this five-game losing skid. And here's the lineup. Leading off will be Bryant Hunter. Batting second, Damian Easley. The third batter, Bobby Higginson. Batting fourth, Tony Clark. Batting fifth, Luis Gonzalez. The sixth batter, Frank Catinonato, is the DH today. Batting seventh, Joe Randa. The eighth batter, Rodolfo Casanova. And batting ninth, Billy Ripken. And Buddy Bell hoping that the Tigers will start swinging the hot bat and score some runs. And defensively for the Yankees in the outfield, Reigns, Williams, and O'Neill. Around the infield, Brocious, Jeter, Knobloch, Martinez, Girardi behind the plate, and David Cone on the mound. 0-1 with a high 14.90 earned run average. Both of his starts have been against Oakland this year.
And Hunter looks at that first pitch from Mr. Cone. It's inside, ball one. Hunter had two walks and struck out three times in last night's game, 0-for-3. He's looking, and the count evens 1-1 on Bryant. Tigers trail it 1-0 in the bottom of the first inning. Wide breaking ball down to the way, 2-1. Cohn, the right-hander, native of the Kansas City, Missouri. Fouled away. And the count 2-2 on the Tiger leadoff man. Breaking pitch inside makes the count full. Cohn, a one-time Cy Young Award winner. He walks him. Well, the Tigers get their leadoff man on. Hunter does what he did last night. Starts the Tigers first inning with a walk.
There's the numbers for David, 0-1, and you can see the high earned run average. Also, David Cohn, very easy to run on. He has a high leg kick. I'm sure with Brian Hunter on first base that he will be shortening up his leg kick towards home plate. But he's very easy to read if you're a good base stealer.
He's easily moved up to the number two slot in the batting order. Damian had a double and a single in the walk. Bounced to second base in last night's game. The move is average to 333. 1-0 Yankees. High in tight on Easley, ball one. Cohn got his start with the Kansas City organization. He's been with them twice. He's been with the Blue Jays twice. And had some great years also with the New York Mets. He was a 20-game winner with the Mets. There's a strike called. 1-1 the count on Easley. Perry Hill coaching at third.
Well, there's an advantage and there's a disadvantage batting second in the lineup when you have a speed runner like Brian Hunter. You have to take a lot of pitches, but also you have to take a lot of fastballs right down the middle.
Fouled away.
You have to give the base runner a chance to try to steal a base if you can, so consequently you have to take a few pitches. But on the good side, normally you'll get a lot more fastballs to hit.
Record right there. 1-0 Yanks, first inning. Two-two, the count on Easley, 100 first. That's Tino Martinez over there with him. The full count again. That's the second time in two hitters that Cohn has gone to that count. There he goes. High foul off of first base. Martinez grabbing it, and Hunter retreats and holds it first. One on, one out for Bobby Higginson.
O'Brien was off and running on that last pitch. Of course, David Cohn took a little bit more time, delivering the ball to home plate because he knew the base runner was going to be running anyhow.
Well, Brad's gotten a lot of help from the Tiger coaches. Let's tune in about that.
Jerry White, he's done a good job. He his job at first base is very important because what he does, he gives you times what the pitchers are to the plate. And he's over there seeing things that we normally can't see. When I'm on first base, I'm looking at a pitcher, and it may take me three or four pitches to really see what his key is to the plate that I can pick out where I can steal off him. Jerry's over there, and he's just focusing straight on him. I got a lot of things to do. I got to pick up where the position of the outfielders, position of the infielders. I got to pick up the signs. I have to worry about getting back to first base from the catcher. So there's so many things that I'm caught up and busy with that Jerry kind of relieves for me.
Jerry also has a stopwatch, and he times the delivery from the pitcher to home plate, and he will relay that to the base runner and saying that, well, he's taken so many seconds to deliver the ball. And that's a key if the base runner thinks he can get a good jump.
Bobby Higginson up for the man on and the man out. He had a two-run double last night, driving in the two Tiger runs in their loss to the Yanks. That was his only hit of the evening.
Well, I'm not seeing a lot from David Cohn here tonight. Today so far he doesn't have that good moving fastball, and usually you see right-handed hitters backing away from that nasty slider of his, but so far I had not seen that.
That one's in the dirt, blocked by Joe Girardi.
And if I were the Yankees right now, I'd be very concerned about David Cohn from what I've seen so far and the way he's pitched so far in this season.
Well, as you mentioned in your opening remarks, Al, he's had a lot of problems with that arm in the last year or so. Surgery. Yanks in the lead, first inning, 1-0. They scored in the first after two are out and a double by O'Neill and a single by Williams. 2-0 pitch to Higginson. In time. Well, they say that's a good lead when you just get back.
And it's usually an indication that the pitcher is going to throw some kind of an off-speed pitch to home plate. This is the closest pickoff attempt so far since Brian's been on base.
Fouled away at the plate by Higginson. 2-1 the count on him. Hunter trying to get his lead again. It's inside. The throw to second is not in time. It gets through. Hunter picks up and heads for third, and he will make it easily. So it'll be a steal and a throwing error charged to Girardi. The ball gets away as it's thrown back into the infield, but is retrieved quickly by Martinez at the mound. Well, the Tigers have the tying run at third now with one man down.
O'Brien got a terrific start here at first base. He also got a good pitch to run on. The throw in the dirt. You can see there O'Brien had a trouble picking the ball up, then had no trouble getting to third base. Take a look at the jump. You can see the delivery and then the jump, and look at the strides by Brian. The throw, he would have beaten it, even though it was, if it would have been a good throw, the ball got away from second base. An error on the catcher for Brian getting up and going to third base.
And Higginson gets a walk on a 3-1 pitch. Man on first, man on third for Tony Clark. Tony had a single in four trips last night. and in his lifetime has never had a hit against David Cohn. He's 0 for 11.
Well, I think today is the day it's going to break that string. In fact, I think I'm going out on a limb, Mr. Harwell.
All right, good.
He's going to get his first home run of the year today.
I'd go for that.
And it'll be a nice time to do it here.
Man on first, man on third, one man down, Tigers trail, 1-0 first inning. It's a wide one. He's thrown a lot of pitches so far, Al.
Oh, yeah. I'm not impressed with David Cohn. I've been a David Cohn fan for many, many years. But to me, he doesn't have that good movement on his fastball, and the breaking ball is not biting like it normally does.
One and one, the count on Tony Clark.
It's a split finger there, and that was the ball well out of the strike zone. One of the problems with Tony, I think he's getting a little anxious now. He knows that he's being relied on for the power in this ball club, and I think he's pressing a little bit to get that first home run.
High foul. It'll be out of play over the roof of the grandstand on the third base side. Tigers had another team meeting. Buddy Bell, really not a man who calls a lot of meetings, but he felt like another one was necessary.
And I tell you, it was a long one, 20 minutes, and that's very unusual for a team meeting. And I think basically, with talking with Buddy before the meeting, he was going to say, hey, look, we're in a slump. It's the whole team slump. We can't look in any one area. But we're a good ball club. Let's don't press, but let's be aggressive and play the game hard.
1-2, the count on Clark. 2-2 the count on Tony. Well, Bill Terry, the old Giant manager back in the 30s, had a team meeting before every game. Most managers have, what, 3 or 4 years at the most?
I would imagine there have been a few guys in the back going to sleep in those meetings late in the season.
Fouled away.
The problem with the Tigers is it's a very young ball club, and a lot of the young guys in this team are worried right now, and they don't know if the team losing, they may not be doing well, and they've got things in the back of their mind. Are they going to send me out? Are they going to trade me? And it's tough when you go into a slump when you're a young ball club.
2-2 count. And there's that full count again. We've seen quite a bit of it already with David Cohn in this first inning.
Buddy Bell has a decision to make. Does he allow Bobby Higginson to run? Tony strikes out a lot.
Don Zimmer, Joe Torre, and Mel Stoudemire in order over there in the Yankee dugout. Mr. Hill going through the wigwags. That's Hunter at third. Higginson at first. Ground ball knocked down by Martinez. Throw to second. One throw back to first. They get the double play and a fine stop by Martinez. And the Tiger threat goes a-glimmering. At the end of one, the Yankees on top, 1-0.
Dress up and save now at Mr. Allen's. George Ufertini, 29 and 2 for 50. Stacey Adams, 29 and 2 for 50. San Remo, 29 and 2 for 50. Snakeskin, leather, crocodile print. Save big at Mr. Allen's. Exotics are in at Mr. Allen's. Stacey Adams Exotic Combination, 59 or 2 for 100. The ultimate dress shoe. David Eaton Big Patch Alligators in awesome colors. Reduced to only $2.99. Exotics, Mr. Allen's. Mr. Allen's, Greater Detroit's largest Pelly Pelly dealer, has all the latest fashions from Pelly Pelly for men and kids. Mr. Allen's, now open in Redford.
Face it, we're a nation of feel-gooders and have-funners. We'll pursue happiness just about any way we can. And that's cool with us, you know, whatever makes you feel good. After all, that's where we put the fruit in Fruitopia, to make you feel good. Fruitopia, we just want to make you feel good. And you know what really makes people feel good? Big things. That's what we put Fruitopia in, this big new 20-ounce bottle. That's 25% more free compared to the old 16-ounce bottle. Hey, anything to make you feel good.
Guys like, whoa, guys like me don't get much respect. I mean, I hit big, but there's no deodorant commercial. I made huge plays. I'm not even in a cereal box. But man, I could care less.
Triple Play 99. You've never seen baseball like this.
Who needs cereal?
Whoa.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
You're watching the Detroit Tigers on UPN 50.
Well, we're going to look at the last two outs, and what a play made by Martinez at first base. A shot hit by Tony Clark makes the throw to second and the relay to first base. The Tigers have to be saying to themselves right now, when's this going to end? When are we going to get a break?
Well, two contrasting first innings there. The Yankees had two out and then pushed in a run. The Tigers had runners at first and third and one out, and the double play killed their chances to score. Here's Tim Raines, the switch batting outfielder, to lead it off. Raines had three singles in last night's game, and he starts him up with a strike call. Strike two on the Yankee outfielder, Tim Raines.
Well, Tim Raines has been a great hitter over the year. You can see he's strong to all fields. Doesn't run quite as much as he used to, and usually has a great eye, does not swing at a lot of bad pitches. Those first two strikes against him were outstanding right on the outside corner.
Raines spent most of his early career with Montreal, had a terrific year with him when he hit 334. Best average with them. There's a foul out of play upstairs. Still two strikes on him. Just off the outside corner, one ball, two strikes. Certainly been around the plate so far, Al.
Well, I'll tell you, I'm impressed with Keagle, even though he gave up three straight hits, but that can happen with this lineup. But I think he's moving the ball around. He's able to get the off-speed pitch over the plate, particularly his changeup.
Fouled off the mitt of Casanova, keeping Tim Raines alive with a 1-2 count. Very wide with this one, 2-2. Fouled away, and the count stays at 2-2 on 10.
They're starting two straight changeups in a row. It was a much better one than the pitch previously, but now I can set him up with a fastball if he wants to throw it, and he might be a little late on this pitch.
Full count. Raines leading off of the Yankee second. The New York is on top, 1-0. Fly ball hit deep to center. On the run goes Hunter. He's there. One away.
Well, if you're going to hit long fly balls, that's the place to do it here at center field at Tiger Stadium. A big area for a center fielder to cover.
Yankees have made four outs so far, three of them on outfield flies, the other one on a strikeout. Here's Scott Brosius, the third baseman. Ball one, the count on him. Scott had a couple of singles and was safe on an error last night's game. Struck out a couple of times. He batted number nine. He's been moved up one spot. There's a strike. Mr. Welke said so. 1-1.
Well, here's the hit zone for Scott. He's a pole hitter. He likes the ball inside, particularly the fastball. He's been pulling off the ball and hitting a lot of ground balls to shortstop.
Watch out. That one got him in the back. That slipped away from Keagle. Hit by the pitch. Man on with a man out.
Slow breaking ball here, and Scott says, well, if I'm going to get hit, that's the kind of pitch you want to get hit by.
Got him in the numbers. Joe Girardi, the catcher.
They like to hit and run with this guy a little bit, and Brocious can run a little bit. He's not a speed gamer, but he's a good base stealer.
One time a Cub receiver, Girardi. Joe went to Colorado with the expansion draft, and then from there went to the Yankees. One on, one out. Tony Randolph coaching at third. There's a strike.
Excellent second baseman many years for the Yankees, and I think eventually will become a major league manager. Very smart, very intelligent, and knew how to play the game.
Fouled away upstairs. Two strikes on Girardi. There's Willie in action out at third again. Yanks on top, 1-0. We're in the second inning, second game of the three-game set here at the corner. Transferred from the Bronx to Detroit. One and two. A little housekeeping now by Tim Welke. Ground ball to short, handcuffed, is ripped in, but he grabs it and fires over to second to get the force to Easley. Missed the chance for the double play, but they get the force out.
This ball might have been hit a little bit harder than Billy thought it was. Right, a one hopper right to him, right up there where he wants it, and bob with the ball, but fortunate, able to get the play at second base. That tailor made double play.
The Yankees stay alive with a man on and two down, leading 1-0 in the second. And here's the leadoff man returning to the plate, Chuck Knobloch. He started the game with a fly to Higginson in right. High curve, ball one. He made a career out of hitting against the Tigers. 339. Been on base a lot of times with the old base on balls too. Runner goes. Here's a swing and a miss. Throw to second. Gets away from Ripken. Goes into center field. Hunter picks it up. On to third goes Girardi. So he'll have a steal, and it'll be a throwing error charged to Casanova.
Well, the element of surprise, you don't expect Girardi to be running. He has been a good base runner throughout his career, and looked like they had a good shot at him, but a terrible throw to second base by Casanova. Not a big lead, but Keagle is not paying much attention to him as a base runner. A good pop-up slide and able to get up running full speed to third, goes third base.
Ground ball to Ripken. He guns it over to Clark in time, and that ends the Yankees in their second inning. At the end of one and a half, New York one and Detroit nothing.
You may not always agree on the best plays,
We do have our differences.
That's for sure. But we do agree that your Metro Detroit Ford dealers can get you more car for less money.
That's Ford choice.
There's Escort, lots of features at an affordable price.
Contour, a sporty sedan with serious performance.
And Taurus, the most popular car in Metro Detroit.
Ford choice from your Metro Detroit Ford dealers. Great cars, low payments, and a great selection.
Hey, guys, this is my choice. Not much on gas, but good on ice.
Think Ford first.
Hi, Ray Lane here for your participating True Value stores. True Value means true service, neighborhood stores, and knowledgeable, friendly associates ready to help you.
Get organized with 8x10-inch shelf brackets, 6 for $3.88, and rubber-coated storage hook kits from National Hardware, only $6.99 each.
Stop by participating True Value store for great service, great values, and a chance to win great tickets to a Red Wings or Pistons game. Remember, with True Value, help is just around the corner.
There's a place in Cooperstown, New York, where memories come to life.
It's 7:15. There's a new home run champion of all time, and it's Henry Aaron.
That's it. Number 7 is in the books. Remarkable Ryan has done it again.
Touch them all, Joe. You'll never hit a bigger home run in your life.
Where moments become memories, the Baseball Hall of Fame at Cooperstown.
Hello, hello, hello.
Pretty good crowd in the bleachers today. We have a couple of patrons with their shirts off. I don't know whether it's that warm or not, but nice to see some young people in the stands.
It's like cookie time out there. Gonzalez will lead off for the Tigers. They are trailing the Yankees 1-0 in the last half of the second. Lewis did not see action in last night's game. 341 average in the month. He normally does not hit very well. His lifetime average in April is 241. Strike one, the count on him. Last couple of years he's had more walks in a season than strikeouts.
That's very unusual in baseball today. Most of the time it's really the strikeouts outnumber the base on balls.
One and one, the count on Gonzo.
I'll tell you, the way he's swinging the bat and the way he gets on base, I think I would let somebody else sit out. Let this guy play against everybody for a while.
There's a strike on the outside corner. David Cohn on the mound for the Yanks. Helped by a double play in the first inning. Fly ball hit to right. O'Neill going back. This is going to be bounding into the seats for a double. So Gonzalez starts the inning with a two-base hit to right, the first Tiger hit.
Well, Gonzo continues to hit the ball well. Gets a breaking ball and able to power the ball in the gap over the head of O'Neill. His ball is hit hard. O'Neill at one time thought he was going to catch up to it, but there's no way. The ball hits the warning track, hits the top of the fence, and it goes into the bleachers.
Catalanata will be the batter. Frank is the DH this afternoon. And he bunts, it's in the air and foul down toward third base.
Well, that's a play right there where the hitter does not have confidence in his ability to pull the ball. And you say, I got to get him over. The team expects me to get him over, so I'm going to bunt. I like to see the left-hander pull, but Frank feels he had a better shot of getting the ball down. But you should be able to pull David Cohn. He's not a hard thrower.
He had one time at bat last night and took a called third strike and that time up. Man on second, nobody down. Tigers trail. The Yanks 1-0 second inning. And he takes one up at the shoulder, 1-1. Catalanata lives in Smithtown, New York. That's out on Long Island. He grew up as a Yankee fan. Swing, a little pop fly down the line and right. Here comes O'Neill. It'll drop in front of him.
On to third comes Gonzalez and holds there on the single, and the Tigers have him at the corner.
Well, you can see by the swing that Catanonato was really trying to pull the ball. Well, look how he hooks the ball to right field. He said, I got to get him over some way, and he's able to loop the ball in the short right field. The base runner, Gonzalez, had to hold up. He really didn't know whether the ball was hit that far and was held up at third base.
For the second straight inning, the Tigers have runners at the first and third with one man down. They are trailing 1-0 in the second. Joe Randa, the batter, looking at the ball. Randa having a slow start with the bat. He was 0-for-2 last night with a couple of walks. Looking, and it's a strike to even the count.
Joe is one of the players that Buddy Bell is concerned about. He's taking a lot of good pitches that he's not aggressive, and then all of a sudden swinging at bad ones. So I'd like to see Randa get a little bit more aggressive at the plate.
Man on first, man on third, nobody down. David Cohn on the mound. Breaking ball has him swinging.
That's a bad pitch. He took the fastball down the middle and swung at a bad one.
Now he's behind on the count to 1-2. Comes in to score, stopping at second is Catalanata, and the Tigers and the Yankees are 1-1 in the second.
Good piece of hitting by Joe, hitting the ball just to the left of Knobloch. Breaking ball, wants to put the ball in play, doesn't want to strike out. Cohn gets this one up and just out of the reach of Knobloch at second base.
Raul Casanova at the bat. He did not play in last night's game. Fouled away. Casanova has been alternating with Joe Oliver, and he played in 6 of the 14 games so far. Two men on, nobody down, a game tied, 1-1, second inning. Strike 2 on Casanova. What's he going to get now? Is he going to waste one, or is he come after it?
Well, you never know with David Cohn. I would think he'd try for a strikeout.
Been retired in this inning. A double, 2 singles, a hit batter. But the Tigers have the bases loaded for Billy Ripken, the number 9 hitter.
Well, that was, I'm sure, a waste pitch, but he wasted it too much to Casanova. I think he wanted to come way inside and then throw him something on the outside corner.
Ripken had gone 0-for-13 until last night when he had a walk and a single and a fly to left. He fouls this one away over back at first base.
Well, we should mention that Bip Roberts not in the lineup as the DH or left fielder. Bip has a problem with his foot, but he's available for duty if needed.
Strike 1 count on to Billy Ripken. Fly ball to right. Here comes O'Neill. It's a short fly. The tag at third, and everybody holds. Ball hit into short right field and picked off by O'Neill.
No chance on that ball. Was not hit that far, and O'Neill, even though he doesn't have a great throwing arm, is very accurate. No chance for the runner to score from third base.
Now the top of the batting order coming around again. Brian Hunter, who in the first inning drew a walk. One-one tie. Each team with one run and three hits were in the second inning. Strike one. Two strikes on Hunter. Drive picked off by Knobloch, throw to Martinez, double play, and the Tigers have to settle for one. At the end of two, the game tied 1-1.
Come along.
Mailman, it's been a long time.
Whoa! Mailman! You grew hair!
That's right. Couldn't have done it without my Rogaine.
The new Rogaine Extra Strength for Men. It's concentrated. It gets more to the root to grow 45% more hair than the original.
Nice rebound.
Carl, sign my Rogaine?
The new Rogaine. 45% more hair.
It delivers for me.
Recently, a group of homeowners were told the windows they bought were just as good as Anderson. Unfortunately, they discovered that wasn't the case. A jury agreed on March 19th, 1997, in a New Jersey court of law. So, if anyone ever tells you another brand of windows is just as good as Anderson, ask them if it'll hold up in court. Worry-proof, time-proof. Anderson Windows.
Come on, girl.
Ooh, baby, we've got more copies of new releases than ever before. Go to Blockbuster and go home happy.
Rent Kiss the Girls tonight and go home happy. For Alex Cross, solving crimes was always professional until it became personal. Now the only one who can help is the only one that got away. Kiss the Girls, rated R from Paramount Home Video. Rent it tonight at Blockbuster Video.
This is your home for Tiger Baseball, UPN 50.
It's what every Red Wing fan has been waiting for, the Stanley Cup playoffs. And you can see the Red Wings only on UPN 50. Round one begins Wednesday night. The Wings defend the cup against the Phoenix Coyotes at Joe Louis Arena. Join Kent Daniels, Mickey Redmond, Ray Lane, and Tim Swarm only on UPN 50, your 10 o'clock news station.
Go Wings. Well, that last play, another mental mistake by the Detroit Tigers. I really believe Casanova forgot how many outs there were. You cannot blame that on the coach because he reminds them every time there's only one out, don't get doubled up. Casanova obviously forgot how many outs there were.
Derek Jeter leading up for the Yanks in the third. It is a 1-1 tie here at the corner. The Tigers have been victimized by double plays in each of the first two innings. And all to count on the Yankee shortstop. First time up, Jeter hit a ball up the gap in left center. Hunter made a great running catch. There's a strike, 2-1.
Well, here's the power by Jeter. Hits the ball right center, left center field. Good hitter. That's why he hits with a good average.
2-2 the count now. Greg Keagle on the mound for the Tigers. Yielded a run in the first inning of the Yankees on a double by O'Neill and a single by Bernie Williams. Two-two pitch. Fouled away. That's in the seats, bouncing around back of the Yankee dugout.
see that last swing. That's because they know Keagle has come up with a good changeup and thrown a lot of breaking balls, and he surprises the Yankees with a good fastball.
Another one. Fouls another one away. Jeter wearing number 2, one of the low numbers. The Yankees have not retired. Most all the others have been taken. And he strikes out. Keagle racks up his second strikeout of the afternoon.
And here's a good fastball, maybe just a little out of the strike zone in today's game. Yeah, that's a little above the waist. And just not able to catch up to it.
O'Neill had a double in the first inning and scored the Yankee run. Ball one, the count on Paul. One out, nobody on. We're in the third. It's a tie, 1-1. 9-for-11. That's pretty good. Outside, 2-0 on the right fielder. Sunshiny Saturday here at the quarter. Hope you'll be out here tomorrow. These two teams conclude the series. Here's a ball outside on O'Neill. 3-0. Well, Keagle's not really been behind on anybody much, but certainly behind here on O'Neill. Took a cut at 3-0, but he couldn't find anything.
Well, these are the hitters that can do most of the damage for the Yankees, and Keagle knows that, and he's being a little bit more careful with his, particularly his three guys coming up in the order.
Got the corner, full count.
And we're going to take a look at the location of that last pitch. And that ball was maybe an inch, 2 inches outside from our overhead camera. But that's the pitch that the umpires are calling more. They're giving that pitcher the outside and maybe an inch or so further out for strike.
He didn't get that one. It was too wide, and a base on ball is issued to O'Neill. That's the first walk given up by Keagle. And the batter will be Bernie Williams, who singled in the first. I got O'Neill home with a Yankee run. Switch batting outfielder. One on and one out for the Yanks in a 1-1 tie. Clouds now obscuring the sunshine here at the corner. Bernie taking, it's a wide one. That one's high, and Casanova wants a conference. Now we were talking about numbers. Remember Cliff Mapes, who
absolutely
played for the Yankees?
Certainly.
He wore two great Yankee numbers. He had number 3 after Babe Ruth quit and before they retired his number. And he wore number 7 before Mickey Mantle. So he's got a couple of pretty good numbers retired.
You're absolutely right.
But not in his name.
You're right. They've how many numbers have they retired?
Oh, I don't know. The whole bunch of them.
Bunch of
8 or 10 at least. One on, one out. Here's Williams waiting on a 2-0 pitch. And that's a strike. Yanks got one in the first. The Tigers counted with one in the second. We're now in the third.
Always puzzled me about a hitter when you have two balls and no strikes, why they're looking at the third base coach. What are they going to say, take the pitch?
There's some familiar numbers up there. I saw number six. 3-1 the count.
Now this is, see, he's getting a sign. I don't understand why he's getting a sign. If the ball strike you, you want to hit it. If it's ball, you take it.
That's pretty basic, isn't it?
Pretty basic. I just don't understand it.
And he walked him. It was outside. That's back-to-back walks after the strikeout of Jeter. And the Yankees have a threat to break this 1-1 tie. Tino Martinez up there among the leaders in RBIs. He got four with a first inning grand slam last night.
Well, he's been on an RBI tear recently.
Infield in double play depth against him. And he fouls it away.
Tino doesn't run that well. They would love to see him hit a ground ball to second base and turn a double play.
Strike one delivery. He pops it up out into the infield. The infield fly rule now invoked. Catch is made by Easley. They are two down. And that leaves it up to Strawberry. He ended the first inning by taking the call third strike. Straw man. He's had a hot bat. Two on, two out, 1-1 tie. Third inning at the corner. 1-1. How would you analyze his hitting stance, Al?
Well, you know, he's pretty much straight up. He's definitely a low ball hitter. If you have a good fastball, they like to come up and into him and throw him real slow stuff. He's so strong, if he gets his arms extended, he's very strong, hits a lot of balls to left field. He had a mammoth home run in Shea Stadium the other day when they played that one game against the Angels.
1-2, the count on Strawberry. Has anybody ever figured out why left-handers are low ball hitters and right-handers the other way most of the time?
Most of the time, yeah. I mean, it's very unusual. Left-handers seem to be much better low ball hitters than the right-handers.
Two on, two out. Game tied 1-1. 2-2 pitch. Ground ball to first. Tony Clark handles it by himself, and the Yanks are out in the third. Tigers bat last half the third. It's a 1-1 tie.
The 98 Explorer Sport is a great choice when you want style, sophistication, and sporty features, all at an affordable lease payment of only $264 per month. The 1998 Explorer Sport comes equipped with automatic, air conditioning, V6, dual airbags, four-wheel anti-lock brakes, all for only $264 per month.
We're 31 Metro Detroit Ford dealers, Big Ford Perks.
What do you look for in grass seed? Quick results?
We seeded it with Scott's seed last fall. As soon as I planted it, boom, it just came in.
A really terrific lawn?
And it feels like crushed velvet under your feet. It's wonderful.
How about weeds? Bargain brands can contain thousands of weed seeds that can ruin your lawn forever.
You can spend a dollar or two less for a bag of seed.
But you don't want weeds in your grass seed.
Scott's Premium Grass Seed, 99 and 99 100% weed-free for a beautiful lawn guaranteed.
Well, it's time for our game summary. Much better game than last night. Williams RBI single in the very first inning. And here's the stolen base by Brian Hunter. A good jump, a bad throw to second base. Brian able to get himself up and go to third base. And here's the RBI base hit by Joe Randa. Two strikes going the opposite way, just out of the reach of Chuck Knoblauch. And we have a 1-1 game, a much better game for the Tigers anyhow, here today than last night.
It'll be Damian Easley to lead off for Detroit against David Cohn. Easley fouled to the first baseman. Martinez is only time at bat. There's a strike called as the last half of the third gets underway in this 1-1 tie. Wind has subsided quite a bit. Two strikes on Damian. It was really blowing before the ball game. It's almost stopped now.
Perfect day to play baseball in April here in Detroit.
Little chopper hit foul over toward the on-deck circle. Strike two on Easley.
Damian would love to have that pitch back again. That's a hanging breaking ball. And, that's one of the problems that Cohn has had so far. He has not been making good pitches with the breaking ball.
There's the fastball fouled away upstairs. Ground ball, deep short, knocked down by Brosius for the first. He got him. Good play by the third baseman, Brosius. Nips Easley.
Well, he has made, that's his third outstanding play that he has made in this series already. Another great play, dives, makes the grab, and is able to get up. And Damian runs very well and able to just get him. Bang, bang play at first base. And that's one of the reasons why they got Brosius to play third base. They thought that defensively they were poor there at third base and second base, and they've really solidified those two spots.
Strike called on Bobby Higginson with one out and nobody on in the 1-1 tie. He walked in the first inning. Two strikes on Bobby. Close. Al Cohn has sort of a hesitation as he starts and goes into his delivery. What does that do to a hitter?
Really not much. You're really not going to worry until you see the arm come forward. It's just a timing device by David Cohn to get himself in position to make the throw. And I guess he does it sometimes to throw the timing off of a hitter, but I don't think it affects him that much.
Line drive, base hit. Higginson, he's on with one down here in the third. Now, old Satch Page, you talk about hesitation.
I mean, you could almost read a book. He would stride and then throw.
Yep.
That we call a real hesitation. That's almost like the Ethos pitch.
Yeah. Well, Satch had more tricks than anybody. Tony Clark still looking for his first hit in his career against David Cohn. He hit a double play to end the first inning. Strike called on Clark.
Remember the first time I saw Satchel Paige was I joined the ball club and we went to St. Louis, and he had come back to the Brownies, and they had a rocking chair for him down in the bullpen.
Say he used to warm up, they'd put a little match pad so he could throw over it instead of home plate. Two strikes. I saw Satchel in the World Series in 1948. He came up in late 48, pitched for the Indians in that World Series against the Braves.
I guess he could bring it pretty good, couldn't he?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Long, lanky guy, had a great arm.
And in his day, he would pitch maybe two or three games a day sometimes.
Well, you can see the area where I think Tony likes the ball, up middle of the plate, down. He has a little trouble with the high fastball, but he likes to extend those big strong arms of his.
1-2 the count on him. Struck him out. It's the first strikeout this afternoon for Cohn. Two down, one on, and a 1-1 tie. And Gonzalez, who has scored the tiger run, is the batter.
And the last pitch to Tony. Up and out over the plate. And he does have Tony's number. He has never gotten a hit off of David Clone.
Gonzalez started the second inning with a double and then came home on that single by Randa. He looks at the ball outside from Cohn. High fly going foul back to third. Chased by Brosius, but he can't get there.
Well, he wasn't going to get any help from the bullpen. But he knew he was getting close to the fence. There he is again. Watch this. He knows he's getting close. He can feel the warning track. And now watch how he favors and pulls up.
In close on Gonzalez, 2-1. Young man from Tampa, Florida, having a good start for the Tigers. 2-1 pitch. It fouled over past the Yankee dugout.
Yeah, they're not paying much attention to Bobby Higginson at all. Of course, Bobby's a one station at a time base runner, but they're not paying any attention to him at all.
In close on Luis and the count 3-2. That's the cat on deck, Frank Catalanata. Ground ball to first base, took a bad hop, but Martinez plays it and makes the play unassisted. And at the end of three, this one remains tied. Yankees 1, Tigers 1.
Detroit Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by Little Caesars. Little Caesars Big Big Pizza dwarfs the competition.
Nobody does it like you.
Nobody has harnessed the power of the wind like Wind Tunnel by Hoover. A breakthrough in cleaning power. Hoover tested Wind Tunnel against other leading brands. The difference is remarkable. Others scatter much of the dirt, but Wind Tunnel channels the power of the wind, picking up more dirt than any other clean air upright. Only from
Hoover. Nobody.
Wind Tunnel by Hoover.
Does it like you.
Both these men have athlete's foot. Only one used Desinex, the soothing cure. Desinex has a dual-action formula that calms the itching and cools the burning. And Desinex is clinically proven to kill the fungus dead, so your feet feel good while they heal. Got athlete's foot? Get dual-action Desinex, the soothing cure.
Gary Sheffield, outstanding bat speed. Pull the ball with the best of them.
The secret to MLB 99's realism? Scouting reports straight from the pros.
Favorite cheese, Gouda. Whoa. Bobby Bonilla, weakness for fastballs in the dirt. Has a dog named Snacks.
Oh, that's impressive.
I knew that.
You drive a 71 Nova, make $22,000 a year, and you were a bedwetter.
Hey, better.
PlayStation.
This is UPN 50, the home of Tiger Baseball.
All tied up, 1-1. We're going into the fourth inning. The New Yorkers coming to bat with their left fielder, Tim Raines. Tim flied to center starting the second inning against Greg Keagle. Switch batter waiting.
And taking inside ball one. Yankees got one of the first. Tigers came back with one of the second. Neither team scoring in the third. Line drive right to the glove of Easley for the out.
Ball hit sharply but right at Damien. Did not have to move. The ball had a little sink to it. This is the two innings that Keagle has had problems so far this year, the fourth and fifth inning.
There's a fly ball to short right. Maybe trouble. Here comes Higgy. He's got it on the run. Well, Easley went back. Clark went back, but Higginson raced in from right field to pick it off.
Yeah, Bobby had a long way to go. They play Brocious pretty much to be a pull hitter. I don't believe Tony could have gotten it, and an outfielder should call, and Bobby Higginson made a good, good running catch.
Two out, nobody on for the Yanks in the 1-1 tie in the fourth, and here's Joe Girardi, who batted one time so far, hit into a force out on a ground ball to short. He's looking at the ball on Joe, the veteran from Northwestern University. There's a drive to left. It will be in the left field corner off the wall. Gonzalez plays it off the wall. It's a two-bagger for the Yankee catcher Girardi. Their fourth hit and their first one since the first inning. Well, the Yanks score their run in the first after two are out. Now they've got a man on second with two down. Knobloch, the leadoff man, up for the third time. He's flied to right. He's bounced to short. Chuck from Texas A&M. It's a high one, ball one.
He jumped right to the big leagues from Orlando, I believe, with the Twins.
You're right. Came up in 91.
Well, he's been a good player, and they feel he's the guy that's going to put the Yankees over the top. He solidifies their defense and also is a great leadoff hitter.
Here's a strike, 1-1 on the Knobloch. Girardi on its second with two down, a 1-1 tie, fourth inning. Sun trying to get through the overcast. It's a weak sunshine right now. There's a ground ball to deep short, backhanded by Ripken, the long throw to Clark, and they nip him by half a step. And that's all for the Yanks in the fourth inning. Tigers batting the fourth, still tied, 1-1.
Tigers opening animation created by Brain Cell Pictures. Sound design by Paradise Post. Farmington Hills, Michigan.
Troy Aikman is back to pass. He's looking, looking, look out. Oh, Aikman goes down.
He had a man wide open. What was he thinking?
Brute, it's all part of the game.
All right, guys, same play.
Glidden and Home Depot together, it's an unbeatable combination.
We are a paint store in Home Depot.
Glidden's been around 120 years, and they know paint.
It's unbeatable.
So I can always honestly recommend that you use Glidden paint.
It applies easily, doesn't splatter because it's a nice thick paint.
And you just get a brush and roller and go at it. It covers really well.
It's a quality paint. Good durability, good price.
Glidden has it all. You don't stay in business for 120 years if you don't have good exterior paint.
Racist, nutrageous. So loaded, you don't eat it, you survive it.
The Motor City Blockbusters are making the world a safer place for at-risk children. Allstate volunteers are helping to tear down abandoned houses and cleaning up neighborhoods in Detroit. Recently, Wayne County Executive Ed McNamara stopped by to lend a hand. These dangerous eyesores are replaced with new, safe family housing.
We want to renew neighborhood pride and the spirit that comes along with that.
Make a difference. Call the Motor City Blockbusters. This Sharing Together message is brought to you by Allstate Insurance and UPN 50.
There they are, Al, the retired Bronx Bomber numbers, beginning with the great Babe at number 3 and going up to 44 with Reggie Jackson.
14 players, all players with the exception of Casey Stengel, the great manager for the Yankees.
Here's the cat up for the Tigers, and he drives one into right. It is his second straight hit in this game. He makes a big turn and holds, and the Tigers have the leadoff man on. 2 for 2 for Catalanata.
Cat's always been a good hitter every place he's ever played. And this time jumps on the first fastball by David Cone and hits it hard. It looked like he was going to get in the gap, but Paul O'Neill got over there quickly.
Now Joe Randa, who has the Tiger RBI for the afternoon at the plate, he singled in a run in the second inning. 1 for 1 for Joe. Ball one, the count of the Tiger third baseman. Game tied, 1-1. We're in the fourth here at the corner.
The Tigers trouble scoring runs. Wouldn't be surprised to see Buddy Bell put on some kind of a hit and run play. Tigers have got to force the issue, make the Yankees make some mistakes, get some base runners.
Catalanata at first base. Nobody out. Game tied, 1-1, fourth inning. Ball on the count. Randa fouls it away. Now we saw those low numbers of the Yankees that had been retired, and mainly because when they first gave out numbers, they did it by the spot in the batting order.
I remember that.
So that's why you see Babe Ruth hit number 3 most of the time. Gary hit number 4. Two on the count on Randa.
What if the manager say Babe Ruth was hitting third and all of a sudden he's going to hit him fourth? Would he have to change to 4?
A good question. I don't think so. Two-two, the count on Randa. Say, hey, let me change my shirt. I'll be up there in a minute. Tigers and the Yanks tied 1-1. 2-2 the count on Randa. There's that full count. Cone's seen that quite a bit. Well, Casanova waiting on deck.
I would think they'd be running the base runner here. Randa usually puts the ball in play. Doesn't strike out a great deal.
He's going.
Struck
him out. Throw to second. Not in time. It'll be a steal for the Cat. A strikeout of Randa will be the second recorded by Cone. The Tigers get their second steal of the afternoon. Here's Casanova hit by the pitch in the second inning.
Good deal, good piece of base running. You see Catalanato running and then picking up the ball in case the ball is hit and put in play.
In the dirt, blocked by Girardi. Ball one, the count on Casanova. One-one tie. We're in the fourth at the corner. Ground ball foul, hit down past first base. Did pretty well against the Yankees. Tigers had a lot of scoring chances early in this game. They've capitalized on one. There's a fly ball to right. Going to drop in front of O'Neill. Catalanata held at third, and they've got him at the corners again. Man on first and a man on third. three out of the four innings. Well, the Tigers have had this situation now, man at first and third, and one away.
It's one of their big problems, among other things. The Tigers have not been able to get base hits when they had men in scoring position. You notice most of the home runs the Tigers have this year have been with nobody on base, and they have not been getting the key hits.
Here's Billy Ripken now. They've got the infield back in double play depth. Ball one to Billy Ripken. Fouled away, that'll reach the seats in the right field corner. 1-1 the count on him. Yankees got a run in the first, the Tigers got one in the second. That's it so far. 1-1 pitch. Fouled down the right field line. O'Neill coming over, and it hits the seats and bounces back.
I think the Tigers would love to see him make the play.
Yeah.
With Ashore, the base runner, scoring third base. Always, as a former right fielder, you always wonder whether what you should do in a spot like that, whether or not you should catch the ball or let it drop. There's no way you could throw out the base runner.
1-2 the count. And he got him on a strikeout. That's a big strikeout for Cone. He racks up his third of the afternoon.
Billy plays, stands a long ways from the plate, but watch how he bails out. Watch how his head comes off. And boy, usually when you stand that far from the plate that you dive into the ball. He sort of steps into the ball, but pulls his top half of his body away from it.
That leaves it up to Hunter with runners at the corners, and Brian looks at a strike from Cone. Walked in the first, lined in a double play in the second. Ground foul past first base. Down to the Yankee bullpen. Tigers have 1 run, 5 hits. The Yanks 1 run, 4 hits. Strike two on Bryan. One and two. Chopper foul back at the plate. There's the man at third, Catalanata. Casanova's the man at first. 1-2 the count on Hunter. Center field, here comes Bernie Williams. He won't get it. The Tigers take the lead. The cat crosses the plate on the RBI single by Hunter, moving Cassett over to second. 2-1 Tigers.
Well, Brian determined to put the ball in play, not to swing and miss, because his great speed, that you can never tell what could happen, but he's able to loop this ball in the short center field. Finally, a Tiger able to get a big hit with a man in scoring position.
Two on, two out for Easley. He fouls it away. Damien has fouled to first and bounced to third. That was the seventh hit by the Tigers off David Cone. David outside with this one, 1-1. Grounded toward short, cut up by Brosius, throw to second for the force to end the inning. The Tigers take the lead at the end of four. They're on top of the Yanks, 2-1.
Hey, if there's one thing we all have in common, it's having fun. It doesn't matter how, where, or why. And that's cool with us. We like it when people feel good. After all, that's why we put the fruit in Fruitopia. Fruitopia. We just want to make you feel good. And you know what really makes people feel good? Big things. That's why we put Fruitopia in this big new 20-ounce bottle. That's 25% more free compared to the old 16-ounce bottle. Hey, anything to make you feel good.
What does it feel like to have power? What does it feel like to stand up and be heard? What does it feel like to say yes? To say no? To change? What does it feel like to demand respect? To be free? What does it feel like to be in control? Be in control. Find out.
Did you know that exposure to secondhand smoke can increase your risk of lung cancer 30 to 40%? So if you're working around secondhand smoke, in a way, you're a smoker too. Because when it comes to lung cancer, one cigarette can go a long way. Why smoke when you don't? For more information on making your office smoke-free, call 1-800-537-5666.
You're watching the Detroit Tigers on UPN 50.
Well, a couple of the young fans here, and one, obviously, a Yankee fan. That's an old hat. That's a red hat. I don't ever see one Yankee.
Red Yankee.
And, of course, the Tiger English D. But we don't care who you root for. Just come on out to the ballpark and have a lot of fun.
When you were growing up in Baltimore, were you a Washington Senator fan?
In a way, I was. But, you know, because the Orioles was a franchise of the Philadelphia Phillies when I was a youngster going out to watch the old Orioles in the International League, I was a little bit of a Phillies fan. Mm-hmm. Because of all the players that played there, eventually some of them went up to the Phillies.
Here's Jeter to lead it off for the Yanks, and he takes the ball.
But my favorite team really was St. Louis. Only because my favorite player in those days was Stan Musial.
Wow. Well, you were along with a lot of people.
Yeah, you bet.
Base hit by Jeter. Left field single by the Yankee shortstop beginning the fifth inning. Tigers on top here, 2-1. That's the first time the Yankees have been able to get their leadoff man on base.
Well, here's the inning that Keagle has had troubles in, the fourth and fifth inning. And a leadoff base hit. Now he has to go through the heart of the lineup. Four of the toughest left-handed batters you ever want to see.
Beginning with Paul O'Neill, then it'll be Williams and Martinez to follow. Infield and double play depth. O'Neill a double and scored the Yankee run in the first inning. Next time up, he drew a walk. That one gets by Casanova. Jeter will easily take second. It's a wild pitch.
Well, we'll take a look at it again. He wants the ball down in the strike zone outside. He throws it down, but in the middle of the plate. Casanova expecting the ball outside, and the one thing you can't do as a catcher to anticipate where the ball is going to be. You have to be ready to move side to side and block the ball.
O'Neill looking at a low one, 2-0 to count on him.
Well, we're getting some action in the bullpen. A.J. Sager warming up for the Tigers.
There's one outside, 3-0. The count on O'Neill with a man at second. Tigers on top, 2-1, fifth inning. Keagle with a record of 0-2. Both his losses handed to him by the Baltimore Orioles. Ground ball hit on the right side. easily to Clark. The runner moves to third. Now it'll be Bernie Williams against Keagle. Bernie's single drove in O'Neill with the Yankee run in the first. The next time up, he drew a pass. They'll play the infield back. Give up the run for the out. Fouled away. That'll be a drive into the lower deck and left. Well, as a hitter, how hard is it not to grab that bat too tightly?
Well, everybody's different. You're not supposed to squeeze the bat. Williams looked like he was squeezing the bat, but he really wasn't. That's why he wiggled the bat so much. He wanted to try to keep his hands loose. You don't want to tighten up your arms. You want your hands and wrists to be loose and to be able to, much like holding a golf club, you don't want to squeeze the bat. Some players will in situations, but usually you just like to hold it nicely, not too tight.
Do you do that automatically, or do you have to tell yourself to do that?
Well, you do it automatically. A lot of players in tough situations will squeeze the bat too tightly. And, of course, you have to hold on. You have to squeeze it once you make contact because the ball of the bat will drop out of your hand. But to be quick, you have to hold the bat fairly loose until you make about ready to make contact.
2-2 the count on Bernie Williams, man at third, one out. Tigers lead 2-1, fifth inning. Fouled away upstairs.
This is what these Yankee batters, the good hitters, will do this. They'll foul off the good pitches. They know the pitcher cannot make the good pitches, perfect pitches time and time again, so the good hitters are able to foul the ball off and make the pitcher come in there with another one. And Bernie Williams did an excellent job there of fouling the ball right on the outside corner and just found it to the left.
2-2 count. Fouled away. This one back and up into the upper deck. Man from Saginaw will take that one home. Keagle trying to get his first one of the year. He's got a 2-1 lead here in the fifth inning.
Boy, I'd love to see a strikeout or a pop-up right here in the infield.
Yanks have that man at third, representing the tying run. Full count.
Well, you can't give in to Bernie Williams right now, even though you might possibly put him on base, and you hate to do that in a small ballpark, but you have to go with what you think is your best pitch right now.
Full count delivery. Line drive, right field, base hit. The game will be tied. Jeter sauntered home to tie the game 2-2 on the one-out single by Bernie Williams, who's driven in both the Yankee runs.
And he did not have a great swing at that last pitch, but he put the ball in play and hit the ball rather hard in the right center field. Was not a bad pitch by Keagle. Looks like he might have taken something off of that last pitch. But again, a good piece of hitting by Bernie Williams. He fouled off a lot of good pitches from Keagle.
Pitching coach Rick Adair making an appearance at the mound. Tino Martinez who's had a hot stick, is the next Yankee batter. He's had a single and the pop of the second in this game. But he's been their big RBI man so far this year. Ball one, the count on him. That's Strawberry waiting on deck. One on, one out, 2-2 tie. Yanks at bat, fifth inning.
Now Williams is a good base dealer, but he's in a position where he doesn't run quite as much as he probably would like to. When you have someone like Tino Martinez batting behind you, you would give him every opportunity to swing and swing with that hole at first base. He is a pull hitter, so there's a big area right there at first base that he can hit the ball through. But look how far, look where the outfield is playing against Martinez. They get in all the right field. I've never seen a right fielder give a pull hitter like Martinez that much of the line. They're really bunched in the middle.
One oh, the count on Tino. Two balls, no strikes. There's a strike called. There's a long drive foul. The American League leader in RBI right now is Griffey. He has 20. Gonzalez has 18. Stevens of Texas has 17. Martinez and Segui. Segui of Seattle with 16 apiece. Well, that's a lot of run production here early in the season. 2-2, the count on Tino Martinez. RBIs that didn't come into the summers in baseball until 1891, invented by Henry Chadwick, and the National League had them and dropped them that year, and then they weren't picked up really officially until 1920. That's a strike. He's out of there. Williams going on the pitch has a steal of second. Martinez down on strikes, and that leaves it up to Strawberry.
Well, Williams picked a perfect pitch to run on. Here's a slow breaking ball, slow curve ball, and Martinez did go around. I don't think Casanova had any chance to throw out Bernie Williams at second base. Good pitch.
It's a ball outside on Darryl Strawberry. He's made the third out in the first and third inning, striking out and bouncing the first. The Tigers would like to see him do it again. Two and oh, the count. Here's another hitter, Al. They're punching toward the middle on. Ground ball, right side, it'll get through. Higginson picking up the ball, rounding third, headed home. Williams, the ball cut off by Tony Clark, and the Yanks go in front on the two-out single by Strawberry. Here comes Buddy Bell. That's going to be all for Keagle.
That's too bad.
Fifth inning got to him again.
Yeah, got to him again. It's too bad. Keagle really has pitched a fine ball game. He made a real bad pitch to Derek Jeter with a hanging breaking ball to lead this inning off. But a good game. A.J. Sager's coming in, and we'll take a commercial break here.
Carl Malone.
Mailman. It's been a long time.
Whoa! Mailman! You grew hair!
That's right. Couldn't have done it without my Rogaine.
The new Rogaine Extra Strength for Men. It's concentrated. It gets more to the root to grow 45% more hair than the original.
Nice rebound.
Carl, sign my Rogaine.
The new Rogaine. 45% more hair.
It delivers for me.
There's a lot more to transportation than just getting from point A to point B.
Before you ride these bodies, someone's got to make this.
Seaports, airports, subways, someone has to build them all from the ground up.
Before you ride this, someone's got to make this and this and this.
But when it comes to getting from A to B, there is one company that makes everything from A to Z.
So for this.
We're Siemens.
We can do that.
Okay, the new pitcher for the Tigers, A.J. Sager. You can see he's only pitched in three games so far this season. Five and a third innings, five hits. He's walked two and one strikeout. A.J. pretty much like Keagle. Doesn't overpower anybody. He usually keeps the ball down. Pretty good movement on his fastball. One thing Keagle does, he throws strikes and usually gets the hitters to hit the ground balls. When he's getting the hitters to hit the ball on the ground, that means he's really pitching well.
He'll be facing Tim Raines, who's gone 0-2 against the starting pitcher Keagle. Tim applied to center and lined to second. This copyrighted telecast presented by the authority of the Detroit Tigers may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of the Detroit Tigers and UPN 50. Two out, one on. That's Strawberry at first base with his run-producing single that sent the Yanks into their 3-2 lead. Sager delivers high and wide, ball one on Raines. Third year for Sager with the Tigers. He got his start in the San Diego system. Spent 6 years in the minors before he got to the big leagues. Ground ball right side. That's easily over to Clark to retire the Yanks. And at the end of four and a half, New York 3, Detroit 2.
Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by Bell Tire. For price, service, selection, and location, nobody comes close. Nobody's closer.
If you use Right Guard, we challenge you to try new Arm & Hammer aerosol deodorant with odor-absorbing baking soda. Its unique formula is proven to work better than Right Guard to stop odor all day. New Arm & Hammer aerosol deodorant, better all-day protection, much better.
When we built our house, we found a lot that was just perfect.
Yeah, well, it was the worst sight I'd ever seen.
It had everything.
Earthquakes, tidal waves, horizontal rain.
We wanted lots of windows.
I insisted on Anderson windows.
At Anderson, we appreciate the builders who, time after time, make it look easy.
We're still in love with this house.
And I'm still recovering.
Worry-proof, time-proof, Anderson windows. Here are the Anderson quality contractors in your area.
Welcome to Rally's. Would you like to try our terrific 99-cent Rally burger with cheese? Thanks.
Come again. Okay, here's the game summary coming into this inning. Brian Hunter, RBI single back in the fourth inning. Here's Catanonato with his base hit. And Brian Hunter with a little loop in the center field to drive a run in for the Tigers. And Bernie Williams goes down and gets a little off-speed pitch and lines it in the right center field. And the Yankees take a 3-2 lead.
And the pause in action in the grandstand, thrilling everybody here as the Tigers come to bat of the fifth inning. Yankees on top, 3-2. Bobby Higginson will lead it off. Higgy's had a walk and a single. 1-for-1 for the afternoon against David Cone. Tapped, it's a foul down the third base side a little bit. Three runs, seven hits, one error, the Yankee total. The Tigers have two runs, seven hits, and two errors. The Tigers have left six runners, and they've also hit into two double plays. So they've had a lot of scoring chances. In close on Higginson, 1-1. The Yankees have left seven runners. Wide with the fastball, 2-1. Ground ball, deep first base. Tino Martinez makes the play unassisted. One up, one down in the Tiger pit.
Well, it's really surprised me. David Cone has gone this far. I really didn't think that he had the real good velocity, and I didn't see a real good breaking ball from him. But being the true professional that he is, he's been able to pitch out a couple of pretty good jams.
Tony Clark, 0-for-2. The line drive foul. Tony's still looking for his first career hit against David Cone. He's hit into double play and fanned in this game. Strike two, the count. In close, one ball, two strikes. Yankees got one in the first. The Tigers tied it with one in the second. Went ahead with one in the fourth. And then the Yankees recapture the lead with a pair in the fifth inning. Foul back of the plate.
David Cone now has thrown 87 pitches.
In the early part of the game, he went deeper in the count than he's gone the last couple of innings.
He's one of those pitchers, I would imagine, that you have to get him early before he gets his rhythm out there on the mound.
1-2 pitch to Clark. Strike called. He's out for excessive window shopping. That's the fourth strikeout for Cone. He's victimized Tony twice.
We haven't seen this pitch very much by either side. This is what you call a backdoor breaking ball. This ball is outside to the hitter and then curves and hits the outside corner. Look at the ball. It looks like it's going to be well outside and then breaks and hits the outside corner.
It's Gonzalez. He's had a double in the bounce to first base. Strike one on Lewis. His double resulted in the first run scored by the Tigers. He came in on the single by Randa. Three, two, New York on top in the fifth. 1-1. Fly ball hit the left center. Bernie Williams camping under it, and for the first time, the Tigers go 1-2-3. At the end of five, the Yanks on top, 3-2.
Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by your 31 Metro Detroit Ford dealers. Think Ford first.
Making it to the pros takes a certain level of excellence. The experience to get the job done right and a reputation for quality. Having what you need on hand, putting the parts together. for the best possible performance. Being in the pros takes a special brand of confidence, and for professionally trained technicians, that confidence is CarQuest. CarQuest, welcome to the pros.
Not yet. Still not. Nope. Getting warmer. Now it's official. Not really summer till you have your ballpark.
Only ballpark Franks have such a big, juicy taste. They plump when you cook them.
Don't you just love summer?
Flowers, flowers, little flowers.
Hello. Would you like a flower?
Can I have one? If you have two of something, you should share one. Yeah. You have two. Share one. Share one. Share one.
Two for me.
None for you.
This is your home for Tiger Baseball, UPN 50.
Tonight at 8, Alan Barkin, Vic Grimes, and Lawrence Fishburne star as former CIA agents who now specialize in corporate dirty work in the Paramount Prime movie Bad Company. And stay tuned for the 10 o'clock news with Harry Harrison, Leslie LeBue Weather, and Ike Griffin Sports Extra. That's tonight only on UPN 50, your 10 o'clock news station. Yankees coming to bat, sixth inning. They've got the lead here at the quarter, 3-2 over the Tigers. Here's Scott Brosius leading off against reliever A.J. Sager. And A.J. gets a strike in. Brosius hit by the pitch in the second and fly to right in the fourth inning.
He hasn't done much with the bat in this series, but he has been certainly the star defensively for New York. He's made, I think, four outstanding plays.
1-1, the count on him. Keagle started and went 4 2/3 before Sega came in and got the final out of the fifth inning. All three runs charged to Keagle. He allowed seven hits. Walked a couple and struck out three. Foul out of play. Seven hits on each side, and seven stranded by the Yankees, six stranded by the Tigers. Line drive to right. Soft liner for a base hit to start off the sixth inning. Brosius is on first with his leadoff single. And Joe Girardi, the Yankee catcher, steps up. Bounced into a force and doubled. Yankees lead it 3-2. They're batting in the sixth inning with a man on and nobody down. Tigers trying to get out of a six-game losing streak. The bunt out in front. Casanova fires his second. It'll be late. And everybody's safe. That will be a fielder's choice. It'll be a sacrifice. No time at bat. Charge to Girardi. And the Yanks have runners at first and second with nobody down.
Well, Casanova decides he wants to go to second base. It might have had a shot if he threw the ball properly, but this ball is thrown again into the dirt at second base. And the Yankees have their heels kicking up again.
And Knobloch, the leadoff man, 0 for 3 for the afternoon, getting some instruction from third base coach Willie Randolph.
Well, we could see some more sacrificing here, or I don't think they want to gamble on hit and run with two men on right here, but I would imagine they try to move those base runners up over to get the get them in scoring position. But Knobloch does a good job hitting the ball the opposite way, and usually when you hit the ball the opposite way, they don't turn a double play on you.
Well, the infielders have their signs now. Rand has got to be sort of a swinging door down there at third, depending on where that bunt goes, if it is bunted. We'll pick off at second, but back in plenty of time was Brocious.
Had to put a little play on that time. Billy Ripken, the shortstop, broke towards third base, and usually the base runner will lean towards third base, and the second baseman easily snuck in, but Brocious didn't go for it and got back safely.
Knobloch waiting, two men on, nobody down. Yankees lead it 3-2, sixth inning. There's the bunt going foul over near the Yankee dugout. Not a very good bunt by Mr. Knobloch.
You know, I bet you he hasn't had to sacrifice very much in his career, particularly in the major league level. He's been such a good hitter that they've pretty much let him swing on his own.
Strike one, the count on him. Sager on the mound trying to stop the Yanks. They lead it 3-2. 1-1. Pitching out. That's Brocious, the man at second. Girardi, the runner at first for the Yanks. Knobloch waits on a 1-1 delivery. Fly ball, hit the right, it's deep. Higginson on the run, goes back to the warning track, makes the catch. Tagging at second, Brocious takes third. Back to first goes Girardi. They are at the corners for the Yanks with one away.
Knobloch just missed hitting this ball out of the ballpark. Bobby Higginson has to run a long ways right to the warning track, and he turns and wheels to second base to keep that runner on first base. Brocious goes to third.
That'll bring up Derek Jeter, the Yankee shortstop, who fly to set a strikeout and single. His single started the two-run rally that put the Yanks in front of the fifth inning.
Well, we have some action in the Tiger bullpen. Runyon and Flores are heating up, and I think both are ready in case needed.
Ball one on Jeter.
AJ probably be trying to keep the ball down, hoping that he will hit the ball sharply on the ground and turn a double play.
Fouled away, that'll be upstairs, first base side. 1-1 the count. Man at third is Brocious. Girardi still at first, Tony Clark with him. One 1-1 pitch, not forthcoming. He'll deal to first. That one's low, 2-1 on Jeter. Sega ended the game last inning of the fifth. Now working in the sixth, he got the final out of the fifth inning. Keagle was the Tiger starter today. Runner goes from first to second on the hit and run. A base hit into right field by Jeter. Into score comes Brocious, and Girardi takes third, and the Yankees up their lead to 4-2. RBI single by Jeter on the hit and run to right.
And that'll bring out Buddy Bell with this power coming up in the middle of the lineup. Four left-hander in a row. It goes to the bullpen, and Sean Runyon will be coming in to replace Sager. Very, very good piece of hitting by Jeter on that hit and run. Runyon comes in, and we'll be right back.
Not yet. Still not. Nope. Getting warmer. Now it's official. Not really summer till you have your ballpark.
Only ballpark Franks have such a big, juicy taste. They plump when you cook them.
Don't you just love summer?
May not always agree on the best plays.
We do have our differences,
that's for sure. But we do agree that your Metro Detroit Ford dealers can get you more car for less money.
That's Ford choice.
There's Taurus, the most popular car in Detroit.
Now lease a Taurus SE for only $230 per month with $750 cash back. Taurus comes with a V6, automatic, air conditioning, dual airbags, and more, only $230 per month.
Hey guys, this is my choice. Not much on gas, but good on ice.
Think Ford first.
Okay, here's the last base hit. A good piece of hitting. The base runner Girardi is running, and you see the hole there at first base. Jeter does a good job of hitting the ball behind the base runner, and the Yankees now have a two-run lead. The score 4-2. Buddy Bell makes another pitching change. Sean Runyon comes in, and you can see there 10 games. That's tied for the major league lead in appearances, making his 11th appearance. 4 2/3 inning, two hits. He's walked six, which is kind of high. Got a little bit of a flunky move, and very difficult for left-handers when the first time they meet him.
Left-handers so far 2-for-10 against Runyon in this young season. 23-year-old pitcher out of Fort Smith, Arkansas, now makes his home in Iowa. Here's O'Neill to test him with a man on third and the man on first and one man down to the Yankees on top, 4-2. It's a wide one from the young left-hander, ball one. O'Neill has doubled, walked, and bounced to second. Keagle, Sager, and now Runyon. That's been the pitching for Buddy Bell and company today. 2-0, the count on O'Neill. Ball three. Started out with the Houston organization and went to San Diego. From there to the Tigers. There's a drive to right. It's going to be trouble. It is long gone. No, it hit the fence. It's a ball in play. I thought it was out of here. It's a double.
Yeah, hit right on the very top of the fence. The yellow padding that goes across there. The ball was a line drive. Certainly had enough power behind it to get out. It just wasn't high enough. Paul O'Neill jumping on that 3-0 pitch right here. And this is what you're supposed to do with it. When you get a chance to swing at a 3-0 pitch, hits it hard. It's very at the very top of the fence. It bounds away from Bobby Higgins. Tough play for an outfielder right now. You have to judge, can I get to the ball or should I hold up and block it or make the play? And the ball gets away from Bobby a little bit, and the Yankees take a 5-2 lead.
And it turns out to be a two-base hit, the 10th Yankee hit. And now Bernie Williams, batting right-handed, will get an intentional walk to load the bases. Five-two, the Yanks on top here in the sixth inning. Well, Williams had a couple of RBIs and 2-for-2 and a walk. Oh, are they going to respect him with the intentional pass to load the bases with the Yanks? And the batter will be Tino Martinez, who had that grand slam in the first inning last night. Yanks have picked up a pair of runs in the fifth, another pair here in the sixth to increase their lead to 5-2. And threatening to get some more with only one down. Martinez to the single for three today. Runyon delivers outside on Tino, ball one.
Well, you can't keep getting ahead of these behind these good hitters. And of course, this is what happened last night, a grand slam by Martinez. You can't keep getting behind in the count to these real good hitters because they're going to hurt you.
And he is down a 2-0 now on Tino Martinez. Here comes the pitching coach, Rick Adair. Yankees are trying to really break it open here now. They've got the bases loaded and one down. Their RBIs, Jeter has one, O'Neill one, Strawberry one, and two for Bernie Williams. Right in the middle of that batting order. Two-oh the count. There's a strike. Line drive center field. Hunter there. Here's the tag at third. Jeter's coming home. It'll be a sacrifice. The other two runners hold on. And the Yankees increase their lead to 6-2. Oh, Tino Martinez gets an RBI on the sacrifice. Two on, two out for Strawberry.
And here's the last pitch. This ball was hit hard. Ball in the middle of the plate, up in the strike zone, and hits a line drive straight away center field.
Strawberry has a struck out, bounced the first, and single. His single drove in a run in the fifth inning. Had a two-out single to right. Big hook has him swinging. 1-1 on the Darryl. 6-2 Yankees in the sixth. And he does it again. One ball, two strikes. He's the eighth Yankee batter here in the sixth inning. Two balls, two strikes, two on and two out. The Yankees have 6 runs, 10 hits. The Tigers 2 runs, 7 hits. And he got it. If the Yankees do further damage, Tigers bat in the sixth inning, trailing 6-2.
Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by Hoover. Nobody gets the dirt like Hoover. Nobody.
Can you carry a tune or dance?
Who's the bird who's changing the lives of everyone he meets?
Polly.
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 What is this?
It's a flashcard, you idiot.
He's like the little brother I never had.
Hey, do you realize we're both naked?
What's the problem with you?
I never had enough love as an egg.
You kissed him on the lips?
Where else should I kiss him?
Polly, rated PG.
Hey, it's playing at a theater near you.
How'd he do that?
He watches television.
Oh, it's really coming down out there.
Cats and dogs.
It hasn't rained this hard since last time I had to paint the garage.
Man can't work in the rain.
Pity us.
Is that what you're gonna do all day?
I can't hear you.
The weatherman said it was supposed to be nice today.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Eddie!
Jordan is a healthy, happy 18-month-old. But at 6 weeks of age, the story was very different.
When Jordan got sick, Jordan was so young, 6 weeks old, the doctors didn't suspect pertussis until the cough actually developed into a whoop.
Pertussis, or whooping cough, is one of several childhood diseases with serious risks. They are preventable with a series of shots. Protect your child now.
This Sharing Together message is brought to you by the Michigan Department of Community Health, HAP, and UPN 50.
Well, here come the Tigers in the bottom of the sixth inning. The Yankees lead 6-2, 6 runs on 10 hits, and they have made one error. The Tigers 2 runs on 7 hits, and they've made 2 errors.
Well, it'll be Frank Catalanata to lead off against David Cone. He's had a couple of singles. He scored a run. 2-for-2 for the afternoon. Cone's allowed 7 Tiger hits. High fly ball lifted down the right field line. Here comes O'Neill over, but it's in the seats.
David Cone's probably into his last inning. I think they probably have a pitch count on him, maybe 100 pitches. He's got to be getting very close to that right now. Lloyd is the big left-hander.
There's a pitch in too close and the count 1-1.
Mendoza is the right-hander for the Yankees down in the bullpen, number 55.
1-2, the count on him, trying to get it started for the Tigers. They trail by 4-6-2. Yankees come on strong with 5 runs in the last 2 innings. Two two, the count on Catalanata.
96 pitches thrown by David Cone. He's gotten better as the game's gone on. Tigers really had a chance in the early innings to put some numbers on the board, but unable to capitalize on it.
Line foul down past the Yankee bullpen. Ground ball, first base, through the legs of Nikito Martinez. Catalanata holds it first base.
In error on Martinez at first base, obviously. The ball went right between his legs. And he came up and the ball stayed down. It's one of the, it made some great defensive plays, but this is a ball that he thought was going to come up. He came up and the ball stayed down right between his legs.
Each team has been charged with a couple of errors in this game. Well, the Tigers get their leadoff man on. Here's Joe Randa, who knocked in the first run with a single. First time up, and then he struck out the second trip. Tigers need instant runs. They trail 6-2. Fouled away. Strike one on Joe Randa. The Tigers without hits are Easley, Clark, and Ripken. Everybody else has at least one. One and one on Aranda here in the Tigers sixth inning. Well, there's 100 pitches now for David Cone. First pitcher I ever remembered being limited was Milt Pappas when he came to Baltimore. Paul Richards didn't want the youngster to throw more than about 100 pitches, maybe even not that many, and he limited him. I think Milt was about 18 years old.
Still lives in the Chicago area.
Right.
Comes up to Comiskey Park, New Comiskey Park, every once in a while when the Tigers are in town.
2-1 pitch. It's a 3-1 count on Randa. It's Joe Torre with Zimmer on this side of him. Fly ball hit the deep right center, but the center fielder Williams will cruise over and make the catch for the out. One out, one on. Raul Casanova. He's been hit by the pitch and had a single. Tigers trailing in this one, 6-2. He took that first one, a breaking ball. Tap foul in the dirt. Two strikes on the Tiger catcher. Still two strikes on him. Cone's gone all the way for the Yankees. The Tigers have used three pitchers, Keagle, Sager, and Runyon. Now the strike two delivery. One and two.
David Cone coming hard inside, and his favorite pitch the last couple of innings have been that breaking ball on the outside corner. See, that's what he goes with. There it is.
Ruck him out. That's the fifth strikeout for Cone. Here comes Joe Torre out.
Here's that pitch again, the ball that starts outside and hits the outside part of the plate, and Joe Torre is on his way out and will make a pitching change. I think he has to be pretty pleased with the outcome of David Cone, particularly after the first couple innings when he struggled quite a bit, and Tigers could have really gotten him out of the ballgame in the first couple innings, but he was able to pitch himself out of a jam. So new pitcher, number 55, comes in, Mendoza, and we'll take a commercial break.
Steve Eiserman.
Little Caesars introduces Steve Eiserman motion cards. Collect one free with every captain's meal, all for just $9.99.
Pizza, pizza.
If you like surprises, you'll like a lot of tire stores. Steve, they'll quote you a low price to get you in the door. Then you find out about all the extras they forgot to tell you about, like valve stems, mounting, balancing, until, surprise, you're paying up to $20 extra per tire.
Other stores may charge extra for extras. At Bell Tire, get the low out-the-door price you came in for. The extras are free.
When it comes to tires, I don't like surprises.
Bell Tire.
We always beat all deals or it's free.
Well, we're taking a look at David Cone sitting next to his pitching coach, the great Mel Stottlemyre. And there's his total, 6 2/3 innings, 7 hits, 2 runs, 2 earned runs. He walked only 2 and had 5 strikeouts. So a good day's work for David Cone. The new pitcher is Romero Mendoza, a very valuable member of this Tiger, this Yankee pitching staff of a year ago. He both as a starter and a reliever. Was in 39 games, 15 as a starter. This is only his third game for the Yankees this year.
Well, Romero ready to go to work. The Tigers have a man on and 2 down. And Billy Ripken, the number 9 hitter at the plate. Billy's 0 for 2 today. Fly to right and struck out. Hit the ground ball under the glove of the third baseman, Brocious, is into left field. And holding it second will be the cat. That will be a single for Ripken.
Well, they finally got one by Scott Brocious down at third base. He's picked everything that's been hit to him so far in this series. This time the ball is hit just a little bit in the hole. It looked like he was going to come up with it. The ball stayed down under his glove and also under the glove of Derek Jeter, shortstop.
That'll bring up Brian Hunter with 2 men on and 2 men out. Brian's walked, lined a double play, and had a single. Single knocked in a run in the fourth inning. That was the second and the last run the Tigers have scored here this afternoon. They trail 6-2. It's a strike, 1-1 on the Tiger leadoff man. Mendoza's high with this one, 2-1. Mendoza from Los Santos, Panama. Been in the Yankee system all of his career. Tap foul and they count even on Brian. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Tigers trail it 6-2, trying to get some back here in the sixth inning. They've got 2 on and 2 out. Ground ball up the middle. Not blocked. Over to Jeter for the force, and that ends the Tigers' scoring chance. At the end of 6, New York 6 and Detroit 2.
Detroit Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by Gibraltar Trade Center, the weekend public market.
Bobby, looks like you found a home in Bakersville. Holy Toledo, Bob. You've been traded to the Torpedoes. They love you.
Just because you're always on the go.
Shreveport, Bobby. Shreveport. It's a good trade, kid.
Doesn't mean you can't take along the KFC chicken you crave. Pick up boneless all-white meat kernel strips. For a limited time, grab 3 crispy strips, wedges, and a Pepsi for just $2.99. They're ready to go when you are.
2 words, Bob. Kinitsu carp.
Isn't it time for some really good chicken?
I'm Chris Draper with UPN 50's Tim Swart. Tim, let's talk about playoffs. What's your game plan this year?
Well, from the 10 o'clock news to our sports extra team, the players are all in place.
to make another run at the Stanley Cup.
What about strategy? We have a live post-game wrap-up?
You bet we will. With Mickey Redmond, Ray Lane, it should be exciting.
Live interviews with players?
Yes.
Why would anyone watch any other station for Red Wings coverage?
Chris, that's a great question.
Defending the Cup. The action starts Wednesday on the UPN 50 10 o'clock news right after the game.
Our most powerful computers use trillions and trillions of ones and zeros to extract 200 horsepower from just 2.7 liters of aluminum to balance the equation of driving comfort and driving exhilaration, to create abundant space within a slippery cab-forward shape. Then, with just three digits, we made it affordable. The new Dodge Intrepid. 34 trillion bytes to build it. $289 a month to lease it.
You're watching the Detroit Tigers on UPN 50.
Well, there's the line score right here. The Yankees lead the Tigers 6-2 as we go into the seventh inning. We have a new pitcher, Bryce Flory. Bryce is the fourth pitcher used in this ball game. Keagle started, pitched pretty well. A.J. Sager came in the fifth. Runyon in the sixth, and now Flory here in the seventh inning. There's his record. 10 innings, 14 hits, 6 walks, and 12 strikeouts.
Well, the young man from Goose Creek, South Carolina, will face Tim Raines, and then it'll be Brocious and Girardi, the bottom three, in the Joe Torre's batting order. Seventh inning with the Yanks on top, 6-2. Raines looks at a strike. He is 0 for 3 for the afternoon after having 3 hits last night. Close, and the count even 1-1. The Tigers had a 2-1 lead going into the fifth inning, but the Yankees got a pair of the fifth and added 3 runs in the sixth inning, and that's how they got ahead 6-2. Strike. 1-2 on Raines. Raines and Knobloch are the only Yankees without hits today. Two-two, the count on Tim. Ground ball foul down past the Yankee dugout. The first three Yankee runs were charged for the start at Keagle, and then the Sager allowed the next three. Well, that young man will be escorted out. There's a line drive to left, so Raines gets his first hit of the afternoon, leading off in the Yankee seventh. They've had a hit in every inning except the second and third. Now they've had runners in those two. The batter will be Brocious. Hit by pitch, fly to right, and singled. It was his single that started the three-run surge in the sixth. Strike one, the count on Scott Brocious. Man at first, that's Tim Raines. One and one. Got the corner for a strike, 1-2.
Tim Raines only needs 3 more stolen bases to to be only the fourth player this century to reach 800 steals.
Oh, that's pretty good company.
Yes, it is.
High foul. It'll be down into the right field corner and into the seats. Abrosius last year batted 203, and the year before that batted 304.
It's one stream to the other, isn't it?
Yep.
But he's a very fine defensive third baseman, and that's what the Yankees want him for. They thought their defense last year on the infield didn't help their pitching staff at all.
1-2, the count on him. Instead, the throw is going to go over to first base to try to keep the range close. Him out. Man on and the man out. Now the top of the batting order. So it's going to be Girardi coming up. They're the active career leaders in stolen bases. Ricky Henderson ahead of everybody.
They're not going to catch him, are they?
No, sir. Nobody's going to catch Ricky, I don't think. One and oh. The stolen base came back into vogue in recent years.
When you have speed, you can do a lot of games, a lot of things in this game. You can't teach it.
It never goes into a slump.
Never goes into the slump.
Use it on offense and defense. One and one, the count on Girardi. Joe's of the double in three trips. He scored a run. The Yankees lead it. They have 6 runs, 11 hits. Detroit 2 runs and 8 hits. For the seventh inning here at the corner. That one's a little wide, a 2-1. Tim Welke, the plate umpire this afternoon.
Very good pitch here to hit and run on. 2 balls, 1 strike. You don't want to go 3-1, so usually they lay this pitch in there. Nice situation right here for a hit and run.
Girardi waiting now, the 2-1 delivery. Suspicious of Raines over there at first base. That's Jose Cardinal, the first base coach, number 53. There goes Raines, the pitch is fouled away. Into the Yankee dugout. To the count on Girardi. Strike on. He looked at one too many. Flory gets the second straight strikeout.
A good moving fastball right here. The ball looked like it's going to be outside. Swings back and hits the outside corner. Girardi thought it was outside, but looked like a pretty good pitch from our angle.
Here's the Knobloch, the only Yankee without a hit. He's gone 0 for 4.
Look for Tim Raines to be running in this series sometime. If he's thrown out, you have Knobloch leading off.
There's a strike on Chuck. He came into this game with being on base for the last 12 straight. He's not reached base in this one. Yanks on top by 4, 6-2, seventh inning. Pitching out, 1-1.
Well, Buddy Bell was thinking along the same line I was. If Raines is thrown out, then you have your top of the batting order leading off in the eighth inning.
Here's Tim trying to get his lead. Ground ball, it slowly passed the mound, cut off by Randa. The third baseman fires the first in time, and the Yankees are out of the seventh. The Tigers bat seventh inning, New York leading 6-2.
The baddest team in baseball is back. Their fielding is flaky. Their base running is bizarre.
What's he doing?
And their pitching is off the wall. Major League, back to the minors. Rated PG-13, now playing at a theater near you.
Nobody does it like you.
Wind Tunnel by Hoover is here. It's breakthrough technology. Tests show it picks up more dirt than any other clean air upright.
Nobody.
Wind Tunnel by Hoover.
Does it like you.
Gary Sheffield, outstanding bat speed. Pull the ball with the best of them.
The secret to MLB 99's realism? Scouting reports straight from the pros.
Favorite cheese, Gouda.
Whoa.
Bobby Bonilla, weakness for fastballs in the dirt. Has a dog named Snacks.
That's impressive.
I knew that.
You drive a 71 Nova, make $22,000 a year, and you were a bedwetter.
Hey, batter.
Play station.
Okay, it's time again for the game summary. Catanado, two singles, safe on an error. Cone, very good, impressive outing, 6 2/3 inning. Keagle, not too bad either. And here's the Jeter hit and run. It drives a run in. A very good piece of hitting by Derek Jeter. Paul O'Neill doubling into right field over the head of Bobby Higgins and almost a home run, driving a run in. And a sacrifice fly by Tino Martinez really crushed this ball, but straight away, center field. And some more kids that are having a great time here at the ballpark. It really has been a very pleasant day at Tiger Stadium.
Well, the Tigers are facing a 6-2 deficit, trying to get back in this one. Easley will lead it off. He's without a hit today. The reliever Mendoza fires a strike to Damian. Damian has fouled to first, bounced to third, and hit into a force out to third base. Ground ball to short. That's Jeter. To Martinez, one up and one away. Comes Joe Torre out of the dugout. Bobby Higginson will be the batter. They've had Graham warming up. The big, tall Australian will be summoned from the bullpen.
Well, Joe Torre going into his bullpen once again, maybe just to give his bullpen some work here. Mendoza did an excellent job. He was in there, so but he goes to the bullpen one more time as Ernie has mentioned that Graham Lloyd has been warming up. He's ready to go. And once again, we'll go to a commercial and be right back.
Get your Bud Light. You can't hit my friend. Let's go.
I'm thirsty.
Taste that will fill you up and never let you down.
Looks like you're buying.
Make it a Bud Light.
Coach is calling for the heat.
Welcome to Rally's. Would you like to try our terrific 99-cent Rally Burger with cheese? Thanks, come again.
New poodle next door? Heck no, Frazier's here, 5 times a week.
Frazier, weeknights at 7 on UPN 50.
Get psyched!
Well, I'd like to get one of those hats. I wonder where he bought that thing.
I'd say that's a high hat.
Well, there's Graham Loy, the big, tall left-hander. Here's his record so far this year, having another a good start for Graham. Six innings only, allowed three hits and four strikeouts. Very impressive so far.
Higginson hits the first pitch. It's a foul. Strike one on Bobby. He's had a single in the walk. He's bounced to first base. Tigers trail it 6-2, last half of the seventh at the corner. High foul. It will be back and out of play. Graham Lloyd is 6'7". He's around 235 pounds. Just celebrated his 31st birthday. Born and still lives in Australia. Strike two, the count. One ball, two strikes. Hit by Bobby Higginson. Bobby's on with one man down, his second hit of the afternoon.
Bobby breaks his back completely in half. Graham Lloyd not very happy about the pitch before this. It's a breaking ball. You see Bobby handles still in his hands. He dropped it at home plate. Graham Lloyd really gave the umpire a hard stare after this base hit. Watch Graham turn around, and we couldn't see it there, but he really gave the umpire a piece of his mind.
I think that was a look from down under.
Mm-hmm.
Tony Clark without a hit. He's hit into double play and struck out twice. Man on and the man out. That's a wide one. 2-0 on Tony. Tigers trail by 4-6-2, seventh inning. Trying to avoid their seventh straight defeat. Line drive right center to get up the gap. Here comes Bobby Higginson rounding second, heading for third. Bernie Williams up with it. Clark going for two. Runners at second and third. Tony gets a double. The ball gets away from Girardi, backed up by the pitcher, Lloyd. One out, runners at second and third for Gonzalez.
Well, Tony has to be very happy that David Cone has had left the ball game. He had yet to get a hit off of him. Here's the pitch, and Tony swinging the bat real well from the right side. I think this year, look, he hits the ball sharply. Good job by Williams to get over there, cut the ball off. Higginson holds up at third base. I think it was the right call, even though it was a long throw from the outfield.
Gonzalez looking at ball one from the left-hander Graham Lloyd. He doubled in the second inning, his first time at bat, and scored the first Tiger run. 6-2 Yankees. Bounding ball knocked down by Brocious. He makes another good play. Throw to Tito Martinez for the out. The run scores. An RBI for Gonzalez, with Higginson crossing the plate. That will cut the lead to 6-3. And we'll get a pinch hitter for Catalanata. Biff Roberts at the on-deck circle, ready to hit.
Biff not in the lineup. He has a problem with his foot, but he's able to pinch hit. He's really not at full speed as far as running, but he is able to swing the bat.
That third run is charged to the reliever Mendoza. Here's Roberts at the bat now. It's It's the ball outside on Biff Roberts. One and one, the count on him. Six-three, Yanks on top. Hit sharply to second base, Knobloch over to Martinez, and the Tigers are retired. They get one back, and at the end of seven, the Yankees lead it 6-3.
Both these men have athlete's foot. But only one used Desinex, the soothing cure. Desinex has a dual-action formula that calms the itching and cools the burning. And Desinex is clinically proven to kill the fungus dead. So your feet feel good while they heal. Got athlete's foot? Get dual-action Desinex, the soothing cure.
This is the winner of the Total Value Award.
This is the value. This is the feeling.
This is Regal by Buick. And during Buick's spring celebration, the official car of the Supercharged family is even more affordable.
Buick's got a hot new ride.
Choose 1.9 APR GMAC financing and get over $2,100 in finance savings. Or lease Regal LS for just $269 a month. But hurry. Spring celebration is your Metro Detroit Buick dealer ends soon.
There's a place in Cooperstown, New York, where memories come to life.
Way back, back it is.
Oh! Did you believe that? Well, this guy's in another world.
Where moments become memories, the Baseball Hall of Fame at Cooperstown.
This is UPN 50, the home of Tiger baseball.
Tigers trying to get back in this one. They got a run in the seventh to cut the Yankee lead to 6-3. Now the Yanks come to bat in the eighth inning. And it will be Jeter leading off, and still having fun at the ballpark for those youngsters. Clean up a little bit. Well, there it is. Today's quiz. Three players all time have 300 home runs, but no 30 home run seasons. Can you name them?
I know one.
I know one. Well, the experts out there probably know the other two.
Oh, I'm sure they do.
Here's Jeter, the Kalamazoo product, with a couple of singles. He scored two runs. He's driven home one. There's a bunt toward third. It's a good one. Pass it over, fires to first, not in time. Bunt single by Jeter. His third hit of the afternoon.
Well, this is a perfect bunt right down. The grass is a little bit high. It stops the ball. Casanova jumps out there. Very close play at first base. Just wonder whether if Tony was able to stretch a little bit, that might have been an out.
Here's O'Neill at the bat now with a man on and nobody down. The Yankees on top 6-3. Flory fires a fastball high, ball one. Flory is the fourth Tiger pitcher. Keagle, Sager, and Runyon preceded him. Three runs off Keagle, three off Sager. For the Yankees six, they've had 12 hits. O'Neill looking, and it's ball two. O'Neill with a couple of doubles and a walk. Knocked in a run and scored a run. We're in that tough part of the Yankee batting order. Wide at 3-0 on O'Neill. Right. And he walked him. That'll put two on with nobody down.
Well, here's the last inning. Tigers trying to get back in this ball game. Bobby Higginson breaks the bat, was able to loop the ball over the head of Jeter at shortstop for a base hit. And Tony Clark rifles the ball hard into right center field.
A little confab there with Rick Adair, the pitching coach, out to talk with Flory and Casanova. Bernie Williams has had a good day at the plate. Two singles, a run scored, two walks, and he's not going to run. He has two for two. Two men on for the Yanks. They lead it 6-3. Nobody out in the eighth. Ball one to Williams. Hitting in the cleanup spot for the Yanks. That's in close. 2-0, the count on him.
And Buddy Bell made his way out of the dugout, but promptly goes back in again. I guess he got the sign that Brocale, who's been warming up, is not quite ready yet. Buddy jumped out, took three, four steps, then jumped back into the dugout again. I think we may have some problem. We may have an arm problem right here, an injury problem.
Well, Russ Miller's coming out with Buddy.
And I think
that would indicate that.
Yeah, that's why Buddy Bell jumped out. Flores was shaking his arm, and maybe he does have some problems there. And Russ Miller, the excellent trainer, one of the very best in all of baseball, if not the best, out there talking to him. And I don't think they're going to take a chance on him. They're going to have to go to the bullpen, I'm pretty certain. We're going to try to show you the pitch that we think might have been the problem right here. Watch, he releases the ball, and then all of a sudden he starts shaking his arm a little bit. So that was the first indication that we saw that he may have hurt his arm.
Well, they tried to make a decision, and Buddy Bell has made that decision. He takes the ball, and that's going to be all for Bryce Flory, so we'll get a new pitcher, Doug Brocale, and as he comes in, let's take a break.
Arm yourself with a different kind of deodorant protection. Arm & Hammer deodorant, the only one that absorbs and eliminates odor with baking soda. This man used Arm & Hammer on his left side, deodorant without baking soda on his right. Later, odor detectors showed we eliminated odor. The other just covered it up. Arm yourself with a better kind of protection, Arm & Hammer. And if you use this, we dare you to try new Arm & Hammer aerosol deodorant. It stops odor better and longer than Right Guard. Arm & Hammer for better all-day protection. Much better.
Troy Aikman is back to pass. He's looking, look out. Oh, Aikman goes down.
He had a man wide open. What was he thinking?
Brute, it's all part of the game.
All right, guys, same play.
Reese's Nutrageous. So loaded, you don't eat it, you survive it.
Okay, Doug Brocale comes in. He will get as much time as he needs to warm up because of an injury. He has been throwing, so it should not take him that long. He's already appeared in seven ball games. There's his line so far, high ERA of over seven. He pitched in last night's ball game, came in and pitched in the eighth inning, gave up a base hit, but then was able to get out of the inning without allowing a run. So Doug, who struggled, was a opening day pitcher for the Tigers last year, struggled as a starter and pretty much struggled the first half of the year, but boy did he turn his season around the second half after the All-Star break, and he became one of the best setup men in all of baseball. 3-1 three players all time have 300 home runs, but no 30 home run seasons. Harold Baines, Davis, and myself.
All right, pretty good hitters.
I came close twice. I had 29 a couple times. But
Chili Davis is going to have a little surgery on Monday. Harold Baines just keeps on keeping on, despite those bad knees. Well, here's Bertie Williams up, and he fouls off Brocale's first pitch. The Tigers used five pitchers last night, and Brocale is number five this afternoon. 6-3, the Yankees on top in the eighth, trying to get some more. They've got two men on and nobody down. That's the ball high, 3-1. Now, if Williams walks, that walk will be charged to Flory and not Brocale, because Brocale came in with a disadvantage, 2-0 on the hitter. That's Tino Martinez waiting on deck. Pitch fouled away, full count on him. The Yankees scored first in this game. They got a run in the opening inning. The Tigers tied it with one in the second and took the lead 2-1 at the end of four, but the Yankees ripped it open with two in the fifth and three in the sixth to make it 6-2. The Tigers got one back in the seventh to the current score 6-3. Runners go. There's a line drive fouled to the left field corner.
Well, the Tigers were going to have two decisions they were going to have to make, with Frank Castillo almost ready to come back and Cruz ready to come back pretty soon. I think they probably might have eliminated one of the decisions, because Flores will probably go on a disabled list for 15 days. It's Randy Smith. He's got maybe one decision you don't have to make.
There they go again. The ground ball to shortstop, and it is bobbled by Ripken, and everybody's safe. An error charged to Billy Ripken to load the base for the Yanks.
Well, the third error made in this ball game. Billy Ripken, he tried to deke somebody out as if he had the glove ball and was going to shovel it, but never did have the handle on the ball.
Well, here's Martinez. It looks like every time he comes up, the bases are loaded.
Well, he's really had an opportunity to drive a lot of runs in this series already.
He's had a single and a sacrifice in this game. He's also popped the second and struck out. And Tino looking at ball one. Well, the Yankees have a three-run lead, and they've got three men on base. And there's nobody down in the New York eighth inning. Two and oh, the count on Martinez.
Boy, what a spot to be in if you're a hitter right now. Bases loaded, two balls, no strikes. Boy, you have to be praying for a situation like this.
Three and oh, the count on Tino Martinez.
No sign given by Willie Randolph at third base, so pretty much Martinez is on his own unless it's an automatic take in this situation.
It's a high fly to right. Bobby Higginson under it. Makes the catch. Jeter tags. He'll score. It'll be another sacrifice. And the Yanks up their lead to 7-3. They've got runners at the corners with one away. Second straight sacrifice fly off the bat of Tino Martinez. New York for Daryl Strawberry with runners at the corner. Single and a run in the fifth inning. That's his only hit today. Fouled away. Strike one on Strawberry. Keagle started. Sager in the fifth inning. Runyon in the sixth, Flory in the seventh, Brocale in the eighth. That's been the Tiger pitching this afternoon.
Casanova has to be on his toes here with one out. They're going to, I would imagine that Brocale will go to that knuckle curveball. A lot of times he will bounce this ball. So with a man on third, Casanova has to be ready to block it.
Strike one, the count on the Strawberry is going to step away. Yankees had 12 hits last night. They've got 12 right now in this one. The Yanks on top. They've got runners at first and third with one out. And it's an even count. How does he work him now, Al, with this 2-2 situation?
Well, Darryl likes the ball down in the strike zone, and you can get him out with a good fastball upside if you can get that pitch inside up a little bit. He also will chase a lot of breaking, slow breaking balls.
Waiting on a 2-2 delivery. There's a fake and a throw to second. They've got Bertie Williams hung up between first and second. Clark running him back. Now the runner breaks for home easily. Will throw to first base. They get the man picked off, but the run in the meantime is able to score. O'Neill crosses the plate on the rundown. That will make it 8-3 in favor of New York.
Well, Tigers continue to make these mistakes. This is a drill that the Tigers worked on over and over again to a rundown with a man on first base. A lot of times this is a set play by the opposition with a man on first and third.
Yanks lead it 8-3. That's the second run in this inning. Now they are two out with bases empty. And he strikes him out on the high hard one. So the Tigers bat in the eighth. They are trailing the New Yorkers 8-3.
You know, I can tell just by looking whether a vehicle's been driven hard or not. This guy's one of my regular customers. Scorched brake rotors, beat up oil pan, probably never takes his foot off the gas. And he trusts me to make sure it performs when he needs it most. So there's only one brand of auto parts I trust, CarQuest. I mean, you never know. Someday, he might need to give me a ride.
CarQuest, the professional choice.
Found a home in Bakersville. Holy Toledo, Bob. You've been traded to the Torpedoes. They love you.
Just because you're always on the go.
Shreveport, Bobby. Shreveport. It's a good trade, kid.
Doesn't mean you can't take along the KFC chicken you crave. Pick up boneless all-white meat kernel strips. For a limited time, grab three crispy strips, wedges, and a Pepsi for just $2.99. They're ready to go when you are.
Two words, Bob. Kinitsu carp.
Isn't it time for some really good chicken?
Did you know that exposure to secondhand smoke can increase your risk of lung cancer 30 to 40%? So if you're working around secondhand smoke, in a way, you're a smoker too. Because when it comes to lung cancer, one cigarette can go a long way. Why smoke when you don't? For more information on making your office smoke-free, call 1-800-537-5666.
It's America's favorite comedy series, the Emmy Award-winning Frasier, weeknight at 7. Tune in for some fun 5 nights a week with Frasier, only on UPN 50, your 10 o'clock news station.
I don't know what to do with those tossed salads and scrambled eggs. They're calling again.
Okay, Chad Curtis is now in right field for the Yankees, giving Paul O'Neill a little bit of a break out there. And also, we have a new pitcher, Jeff Nelson, the hard-throwing right-hander. A great setup man in the Yankee bullpen. 8 games so far, 1-0 this year. Give up a lot of hits, 11 hits in 8 2/3 innings. Walk 4 and 5 strikeouts. He's really tough on right-handed hitters. Comes 3/4. He has a big breaking ball. A man from Baltimore, Maryland. He played on some of the teams that I played on when I was a kid. Of course, many, many, many years later.
He's a big guy, 6'8".
Yeah, he is.
Weighs about 235, maybe a little bit more than that. That's his program weight, I think. Here's Joe to face him now. And Ronda takes a strike.
With Seattle came to the Yankees in the Tino Martinez trade.
Randa with a single, and he looks at strike two from Jeff Nelson. It was Joe's single in the second inning. It tied the game at that point, 1-1. So the Yankees have come on with some heavy hitting and run scoring. They lead it 8-3. There's a breaking ball outside, 1-2. Nelson got his start with the Dodgers, and then the Seattle drafted him while he was in the minor leagues. And he struck him out. He's the fourth Yankee pitcher, Jeff Nelson. That means that the two managers have used 9 pitchers this afternoon.
There's that big breaking ball, that, and the reason why he is so tough on right-handers is he throws it way out there. It's very slow. He never gets to the plate. And usually a right-hand hitter will give a lot of ground, and that ball breaks on the outside part of the plate.
And he gets a strike over on Raul Casanova, who's had a single in 2 trips. Also been hit by a pitch. Tigers trailing 8-3 in the 8th inning. The Tigers continuing to make a lot of mistakes in this game. 1-1, that's the count.
Something that didn't happen in spring training, and also certainly last year, the Tigers were outstanding team with fundamentals and also defensively.
2-1. And nothing improves your pitching any more than a good defense.
Gotta have it. Some long faces over there right now. Team not playing well, and it's spread out with everybody, not just any one segment of the team, but it's spread out all the way around.
There's a strike. 2-2, the count on Raul Casanova. Cone started, Mendoza the 6th, Lord in the 7th, Nelson in the 8th. High and wide with that delivery. Full count on him.
Scott Sanders is heating up rather quickly. Looks like we might see him in the ninth inning. Scott is delegated to the bullpen to see if he can't get himself straightened out.
Little tapper foul on the pitch in close on him.
Another bat goes. Hitters today use a very thin handle bat, and if you don't hit it on the big part, what we call the sweet spot, you will break the bat a lot of times. Stan Musial used probably the thinnest handle bat of anybody that I have ever seen. I know there's been a few right now, but I asked him about it one time in spring training, and I said, Stan, you know, do you break any bats? He said, no, I never hit them on a handle.
Always a sweet spot for Stan, the man. Yeah. Ground ball, deep first base. Martinez makes the play unassisted, and there are two Tigers gone in the eighth inning. Billy Ripken will be the batter. He's had his single, 1-for-3 in that number 9 batting spot. Tigers trailing by 5, 8-3 in the last half of the eighth inning here at the corner. Trying to avoid their seventh straight defeat. Big bender from Nelson is outside, ball one on Billy Ripken. Line drive to right. Curtis chasing it, takes it on one hop. Ripken gets his second hit of the afternoon. He and Higginson and Catalanata are the Tigers with two hits. Each second baseman in this game representing the players who do not have hits for their teams. Knobloch of the Yankees and Easley of the Tigers. They're the ones who are without hits. Here's Hunter. He's had a single in the walk. Woo-hoo! Big curve got in above the knees for a strike. Here's a line drive to right for Hunter. Ripken turning at second, hits for third, and the Tigers have it the corners with two down. So Hunter joins the Tigers with two hits, and now Easley will be the batter with the man at first and the man at third. Each team with a dozen hits.
And Mel Stottlemyre, former great Yankee pitcher, years past, makes his way out to the mound very slowly. I would think this is to get the left-hander Stanton a chance to warm up in the bullpen in case needed. I think it's more or less just settle his big right-hander down. He's getting his breaking ball up in the strike zone, and that's not really where it's effective. If he keeps it down and away, then he's really tough on right-handers.
Well, he got the first two batters, and then Ripken and Hunter hit the balls about the same spot. Oh, here's Easley looking for his first hit. He's fouled to first, bounced to third, hit into a force out to third, and bounded to shortstop. Tigers need a bunch. They are trailing 8-3. That's Stanton in the bullpen. Eighth inning, 8-3 Yanks. The count on Damian. Little slow roller. Brosius at third. Flips it over to Martinez. And the Tigers are out of the eighth inning. Here comes the ninth. The Yankees lead it 8-3.
Tigers opening animation created by Brainfell Pictures. Sound design by Paradise Post. Farmington Hills, Michigan.
Steve Eiserman.
Caesars introduces Steve Eiserman motion cards. Collect one free with every captain's meal, all for just $9.99.
Pizza, pizza.
So these are really Tim McGraw's jeans?
The genuine article.
How'd you get them?
You'd be surprised what some people do for a cold Bud Light on a hot day.
Yeah, right.
Bud Light is proud to sponsor Tim McGraw.
Ooh, baby, we've got more copies of new releases than ever before. Go to Blockbuster and go home happy.
Rent Kiss the Girls tonight and go home happy. For Alex Cross, solving crimes was always professional until it became personal. Now the only one who can help is the only one that got away. Kiss the Girls, rated R, from Paramount Home Video. Rent it tonight at Blockbuster Video.
This is your home for Tiger baseball, UPN 50.
Well, here's Tim Raines now. He'll be facing a new Tiger pitcher, Scott Sanders.
Scott has really been roughed up in the two outings as a starter. Only 8 2/3 innings, allowed 23 hits and 19 runs. And that is a big, big number.
8-3, the Yanks on top of the ninth. There's a strike call, the 1-1 on Tim Raines. Raines with a single and four turns. Each team with 12 hits this afternoon. Yankees have put theirs the book together a little more effectively. 1-2 the count on Tim. Sanders is the sixth Tiger pitcher this afternoon. Two two the count on Raines. Leading it up for the Yanks in the ninth. For a large part of his career, he was a leadoff man. And he struck him out to start the ninth inning. Now Scott will be facing Scott Brosius. The third baseman with a single and three, also hit by a pitch. Ground ball, deep third. Randa over to Clark, two away. The Yankees have led this game ever since the fifth inning when they got a pair of runs to take the lead. 3-2. They're now on top, 8-3. Girardi looking, ball one. Jones had a double, he scored a run. There's a drive to center for a hit. Girardi weighing in with his second hit and the 13th for the New Yorkers. And he's the only Yankee who has failed to hit. Chuck Knobloch. He has failed to get on base after being on in 12 straight games. So he's still got a chance to keep that streak going. Two down, one on. Ball one to Knobloch. This is the sixth time that he's been to bat. He went up there six times last night. 2-0 the count. Looking, he takes a strike, 2-1 on Knobloch. Yankees have 8 runs, 13 hits, and 2 errors. The Tigers have 3 runs, 12 hits, and 3 errors. Three and one on Chuck Knobloch. Ground ball towards second, easily to Clark, and the Tigers come to bat of the night. They are trailing the Yankees 8-3.
Detroit Tiger Baseball on UPN 50, brought to you by Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light. By Bell Tire, for price, service, selection, and location, nobody comes close. Now more than ever, nobody's closer. And by Little Caesars. Little Caesars Big Big Pizza dwarfs the competition.
I'm Mickey Redmond. It's Tony V's 30th anniversary open house. For 30 hours only, get a 30% discount on the brand new Millennium Sunroom. Plus, a chance to win Red Wing playoff tickets. Call 1-800-44-TONY-V.
Nobody does it like you.
In test after test, Wind Tunnel by Hoover picks up more dirt than any other clean air upright.
Nobody.
Wind Tunnel by Hoover.
Does it like you.
The Hall of Fame salutes Latinos in baseball by remembering the great Roberto Clemente.
Here's Clemente's throw coming in. It's on the target. San Gita has it. He's out.
He goes into second. Makes the turn. Going to try for three.
Down Bobby swings. Drills it into left center for a base hit. So Bobby has gone 5-for-5.
Where memories come to life. The National Baseball Hall of Fame. You're watching the Detroit Tigers on UPN 50.
Well, another pitcher for the Yankees, the fifth pitcher used in this ball game, Joe Torre. Of course, started David Cone, Mendoza, Lloyd, Jefferson, Jeff Nelson, and now Mike Stanton, the fine left-hander for the Yankees. He'll be appearing in his sixth game. He has 3 saves. National Leaguer for many, many years with Atlanta. Spent a couple years at Boston, Texas, and the Yankees signed him as a free agent in 96, and pitched very well for the Yankees last year. A record of 6-1 and a fine earned run average of 2.57.
Well, the Tigers down to their final 3 outs, Al. They are trailing 8-3. The Yankees broke it open in the middle of the game. 2 runs in the 5th and the 3 of the 6th. They added 2 more in the 8th. And Stanton and Girardi will have a little pre-inning conference. Like to remind you that the Red Wings are in action on Wednesday night,
yes,
beginning
sir.
The playoffs.
Yes, sir, and we wish
and
them the very
UPN
best.
And 50 will be there with all their gang to cover the great hockey action.
And the great job that they do.
The Coyotes against the Red Wings. Bobby Higginson to try to get something going here. The Tigers need a lot of runs. They trail by 5, 8-3. He's had a walk and 2 singles. He's bounced out to first base. After Bobby, it'll be Tony Clark, and then the scheduled batter will be Gonzalez. Ball one, the count. 25 hits in this game. The Yankees have 13 of them. Two and oh. Tigers need the base runners. There's a strike. Cone, Mendoza, Lloyd, Nelson, and Stanton. That's been the pitching for the Yanks. High fly ball to straightaway center. Bernie Williams is there. One down in the Tiger ninth. Tony Clark coming to bat for the Detroiters. Tony had a double in the seventh inning, his only hit in the game. That double set up the scoring of the third run. It got Higginson to third, and he came home on a bounce out by Gonzalez. Ball one, the count on Tony. One and one. Eight to three, the Yanks in the lead. One out, ninth inning, nobody on for Detroit. One and two on Tony Clark. Short bobbled by Jeter, and Clark will be safe on the error by the shortstop. That'll be the third Yankee error. Each team charged with three errors.
This ball takes a little subtle hop right at the very end and hit him on the heel of the glove. Take a look at it again. Another broken bat. A change up that he hits on the end of the bat. Ball comes down, takes a little subtle hop and hit him on the heel of the glove. That must be at least seven or eight that we have seen in the last two games.
Gonzalez has a double in the four trips. He looks at ball one. One out, one on. Tigers trail by five. 8-3 in the ninth inning. Strike. The count even, one and one. Fouled away. One ball, two strikes. Stanton, the veteran from Texas. Tony Clark racing around second, goes to third. There goes Gonzalez into second base. Clark holds it third on the double. The second double of the afternoon by Luis Gonzalez. Tigers have him at second and third with one man down.
Well, we've seen this pitch before, but usually it's by the Tiger pitchers with two strikes. This is a breaking ball that he really makes a bad pitch on. Actually, it was a better pitch than I thought. Looked like the ball was a hanger, but he was able to hook the ball right down the right field line. They were playing him well off the bag at first base.
That's Gonzalez at second with his double. Tony Clark on his third, and Biff Roberts, who been to bat one time, coming in the seventh inning, hit in the DH spot. Looking, it's a strike on Biff. Batted for Catalanata and then stayed in the game as a DH. One and one. Each team with 13 hits, each team with three errors. But the runs, the Yanks have eight, the Tigers have three. Reach the seats back of the plate. Roberts trying to keep it going for the Tigers here in the last half of the ninth. 8-3, the New Yorkers on top. Strike called. That'll make it two down.
Well, here's the big breaking ball that Tony's Bip stands a long ways from the plate. And throws that outside breaking pitch that actually hit in the middle of the plate, wasn't on the corner.
Joe Randa batting, and he fouls this one down in the right field corner into the bullpen. Joe singled in a run in the second inning. Since then, he struck out twice and flied to center. Tigers are down to their final out here. They trail 8-3. They've got runners at second and third. Strike. That's two of them. One and two on Joe Randa. In the dirt. Tigers down to their last strike here in the ninth inning. He got him, and the Yankees make it two straight. The Tigers have dropped their last seven. Final score here at the corner, the New York Yankees 8 and the Detroit Tigers 3. Well, that's it from the corner. The Yankees make it two straight, 8 runs, 13 hits, and 3 errors. The Tigers have 3 runs, 13 hits, and 3 errors. And they'll try again tomorrow to see if the Tigers can break out of their losing streak. That's it from the corner. And we'll see you next time right here. So long, everybody.